edition of Thursday Becoming Tuesday Night Throwdown. The fucking exoplanet. Rob Gronkowski's a cocksucker. And I'm gonna bury him tonight. And his big fucking stupid nose. I'm gonna make him wish that he was dead. I'm gonna make him wish that COVID killed him. How's everybody doing? This is the 89th edition of Throwdown. And tonight I am gonna throw down, man. We got Gronkowski being a cunt. Kim Jong-un is almost dead. Maybe. Fucking, you can get coronaviruses from farts. There's a whole bunch of shit going on out there. Yeah. All right. Hopefully everybody's gotten the alert because, you know, Throwdown, I mean, you know, YouTube really hates this channel. I mean, you think YouTube hates the Joe Cronin Show channel. YouTube really, 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 really hates this channel. Corrupted is like fucking just buried all the time. What the hell is this? That's pretty good, fun little metal cover of a motherfucking, what's her face? I almost called her Christina Aguilera. What the fuck is wrong with me? Lady Gaga, there we go. Holy Christ. Well, we got Drew, the motherfucking gatekeeper in the house. We're going to have one of Troy's gay boyfriends call in tonight. And he was going to tell us about some things, but he is going to come on next week, I guess. And we went to play Warzone last night, but we couldn't play Warzone because I didn't want to play without Troy, to be honest. And I guess he fell asleep. And he might have fallen asleep tonight because I messaged him a minute ago and he didn't answer either. So he may be... That motherfucker may be getting up early and staying up all day and then passing out early. I don't know. It's weird.
Could have just watched Raw, too.
No, he wouldn't be caught dead watching Raw.
It took a rare chance at it and passed out.
He probably jerked off and then passed out. I mean, that's at least respectable.
It's true. Hey, I just farted. What does that mean for me?
I don't know.
Can you give it to yourself?
You know, you can catch a lot of things from farts, to be honest. Like a lot of things.
True. Yeah.
But
you know, it shouldn't be surprising. I mean, they're talking about the fecal matter there. It's not so much the fart itself as it is the literal shit that sprays out of it.
Yeah, that's nasty as hell, man. I want to throw up now. Why did you tell me that? The fecal matter?
Fecal matter.
It's just the worst.
You can even get
it
doing an autopsy on someone that died of it.
Yeah, that's why they're like not doing autopsies really anymore. Or at least they're not trying not to.
In New York, they're not even going to give you a defibrillator if your heart stops now.
Yeah, what the fuck? That was weird. Like, what? Why is that? I mean, I could see, like, mouth to mouth. But, so if you have a cardiac arrest or a cardiac issue in New York, you're just fucked.
Basically, a statewide, I believe it's statewide. It says New York, so I would imagine that's the state. Do not resuscitate order.
Yeah, there's a actual do not resuscitate order. That's crazy.
What they say is in the letter, the health department says the order is necessary during COVID-19 response to protect the health and safety of EMS providers by limiting their exposure, conserve resources, and ensure optimal use of equipment to save the greatest number of lives. Well, I have a feeling more people's hearts stop in a given day. Maybe I'm wrong. I haven't compared numbers, but it seems like we're sacrificing a guaranteed loss of life versus, you know, someone who may or may not get something.
Yeah, that seems weird to me. I'm confused at where they're getting these numbers, and especially Casey is Raw's on the phone. Speaking of heart attacks.
Yeah, shit.
You know.
What's up, guys?
What's going on, man? It's Tuesday night. Back. We took a week off last week. I think I was live on my channel. I didn't do a throwdown last week. We're back. What's up, chat? What's going on? Yeah, super chats don't work, but you can use the regular donations the regular way you would. through Streamlabs and PayPal in the description box below. But yes, super chats don't work on over here.
Streamlabs works better anyways.
Yeah, it's better anyway. Yeah, anyhow.
Your money. Take that as a good thing.
Yes.
And use Streamlabs. They want your money.
Yeah, and I'll take it too, man. I will take it right to the fucking bank. You know, Tommy called me last night while I was doing my gaming stream because I was watching all these throwback things. And I got to admit, man, he sent me a really weird DM about how big his dick is.
Really?
Yeah.
I mean, we've seen it before.
Yeah, and that's the thing is I'm saying to him is like, listen, man, we've seen it through that green thing. It's very tiny. You know what I mean? Like, it looked really tiny through that fucking, you know.
I was going to say, either that thing did the biggest disservice it could have for him.
Yeah. Unbelievable.
Well, at one point, it was like, he said he had a 12-inch cock, so I told him, if he offered the proof up, I'll give him $100, and he wouldn't take it.
Really?
Yeah, I'm like, you figure
out how to address that.
What?
I don't know how to address that. I mean,
well, I'm just saying, I just want to see if he has
question
proof.
Your sexuality at this point, really.
No, he said he has a 12-inch cock. I'm like, for a big fat, for a big guy, you figure he's not going to have a big cock. So
come on. What straight man offers someone $100 to see their dick?
Yikes.
I just want him to prove it. I don't want to see it. I just want him to prove it.
That would entail seeing it. What the fuck is going on here?
Man, I'd love to get a piece of your ass. I'll tell you that. You know, Casey, would you ever give up your bodily functions for my mouth? Listen to this. I was like,
thought
oh
about
my
it.
God. I was thinking about it. Like, maybe. Maybe that would be something I would do. I don't know. I might think about it.
I can send you a bottle of fart just in case of...
Well, you don't want to do that right now.
Dude, I had this whole thing planned out today in my basement where this guy was coming over with the heater to put the heater in or whatever, and he didn't finish, and he's got to come back tomorrow. And I'm just, like, wicked pissed because I was going to not come down to the basement for, like, a day. But, like, I've got to be down here now, so now here I am. But I gave it, like, 3 or 4 hours before I came down here. That way, if he was breathing anywhere, it would settle, you know, and then I spray it everywhere. But now I got to come down and spray it again. Even though I'm pretty sure...
Threw an entire can of Lysol?
No, I didn't. No, I wouldn't do that, but I did, like, I just kind of, like, around. I don't know. But the guy... You know, I don't know if the guy got sick back in, I think it was February or something. He got really sick, like, and out of nowhere he was gone. He didn't come to the house to work on our stuff for, like, a week and a half. And he's like, I've been fucking crazy sick. Like, worse than I ever been, man. It's, like, fucking horrific. I don't know what the hell's going on. This was, like, in, I think it was early February. And,
that's the guy that was working on your house today?
Yeah, well, he's working
shit
on the heater. Oh my god, shit bomb.
I pray Gronk has an autistic child in the future and has a concussion, then hangs his own mother and family like Benoit did.
Oh,
hashtag
oh
big
my.
Nosed cunt.
Oh my god.
Oh my god. Dude, that was from cunt angle. Holy shit, cunt angle. That's crazy. That's some crazy fucking shit, bro.
It looks like he's got the autistic bug to him. It just didn't really affect him. You know, like the people that get the COVID-19 but don't actually have any symptoms. He looks like he's got autism but doesn't have any of the side effects of it.
Yeah. Yeah, he probably has him. He probably has it. You know, to be honest. Probably has it. Probably on the spectrum.
It'll pass down. It'll pass down. You're fine.
Give it a hell yeah!
Shit for you,
I wouldn't be shocked if the Bucks went after Julian Edelman. Their receiving core is already stacked. After all this, they better at least make the NFC Championship game.
Yeah, you know, I didn't care about Brady leaving. I already said, like, I'm not surprised he's leaving because they wouldn't get him the things he wanted and the players and all these other things and yada yada blah blah blah. So, like, I'm not surprised, broken line, by Brady leaving. I wasn't even mad. I'm kind of just like, well, that's the end of, you know, that's the end of a huge era. It's crazy. But now I'm starting to get pissed off. Now I'm starting to get pissed off.
Was that, like, 19 years he was with the Patriots?
Yeah. Yeah, I'm fine with Brady, you know, whatever. You know, we knew he was going to leave, and he did. It happens. You know what I mean? But Gronkowski coming out of retirement, what a fucking homo. What a fucking piece of shit.
Belichick after that. You know what would be funny is if they lose this entire season to COVID-19 and then all this investment is fucked for them.
That's what I'm hoping. I'm hoping that happens. I'm hoping this NFL season doesn't happen and then Rob Gronkowski gets paralyzed. That's what I'm hoping. I'm hoping this fucker falls down a fucking flight of stairs and cracks his fucking skull open. That's what I'm hoping. I'm hoping Gronkowski fucking paralyzes himself. That's right. And I know what you're saying out there. You're like, oh my God, man, don't say that. Fuck you. I don't care. I hope he gets fucking liver disease. Fucking out at the club one night, he drinks a little too much and he fucking falls down a flight of stairs and then wakes up in a casket.
I thought he was supposed to be working on a wrestling career anyways. What happened to that?
Yeah. He's going to be wrestling with fucking paraplegia is what's going to happen.
Oh, my God. Yeah, talk about that. I thought he signed a contract with the WWE.
Limited appearances, to be fair. And he did have a couple matches. He won and lost the 24/7 title. So,
He still has the belt.
He's the 24/7 champion.
I figured it'd be gone by now.
We're hearing that it's probably the last fucking time you're going to see that belt, too. To be honest,
thank fucking God. I hate that belt.
Week three of the season, Tom Brady just knocks him over and pins him. Fucking running out of the.
I hope Gronkowski's first child is stillborn. Motherfucker. All right, you cunt. And I hope your wife gets ovarian cancer and then you have to bury her. You motherfucker. You goddamn big-nosed fucking World War II parent should have gone under the ground. Cocksucker. Motherfucker.
Do your thing. Do your fucking thing. Beat the shit out of your fucking dick, Drew. You fucking loser.
Yeah. You're fucking right, man. I'm fucking pissed.
Sound a little upset here.
I'm just, like, annoyed by this guy at this point. He was I had to watch his asshole head the whole time at WrestleMania. And I said, you know, even though he was a Patriot, you know, I like him, but, like, he's such a goof. You know what I mean? He was always a goof, even when he was on the Patriots. But, you know, you like him because he's good, you know. But then in the WWE, I wanted to rip my eyes out. And now that, I'm going to come out of retirement after, like, you know, you could have been on the WWE, you could have been on the Patriots last year. That would have helped a lot because Brady had no one to throw to. And now you're going to come back? Dude, I hope this motherfucker gets lost in Virginia in the woods and gets eaten by a pack of wolves. Like, hate this guy.
Is he just a free agent right now, then?
That was a trade.
He's a cocksucker, is what he is.
He was meant to follow in the footsteps of Aaron Hernandez, but, you know, if he were to hang himself, there wouldn't be any footsteps, right?
If only Gronkowski had killed a couple people and then himself, we'd be over this. There's the Discord for all you crazy bastards out there. God damn it, he has CTE. He could have CTE. Imagine that, he had CTE. I hope Gronk gets full-on CTE, and he locks his brother, you know, the one that they always party out, they always party together. I hope he gets paranoid that his brother is going to, for some reason, his brother is going to leave him. So the CTE takes over, and Rob Gronkowski gets paranoid and barricades and locks his brother in his basement, chained to the wall, and does weird sexual things to his own brother for weeks and videotapes it. And then when the FBI raids his house and finds his brother dying slowly on the wall, they get all the video footage of Rob performing sex acts on and in front of his brother as the CTE engulfed his brain and he went slowly crazy. And then I hope that fucking TMZ gets a hold of one of those tapes. And then I hope that Pornhub gets fucking trolled and somebody hacks Pornhub and uploads that video 1,000 times to make sure everybody sees it. And then I hope that somebody in his family masturbates to it and then realizes later that it was their uncle. Fuck you.
God. Jesus Christ.
I'm fucking mad, man.
Bean. You really think it's him and Brady are going to turn the Buccaneers around?
No.
Are you really worried about that?
I want to see his legs clipped by somebody at the beginning of the season.
This smells like my vagina.
I mean, I'm dead serious, man. I want to see Gronkowski. I was wishing him all the best, Tom Brady, and I was like, I'm going to watch Tampa this year. You know, I'm going to watch Tampa, and I'm going to be cheering for Brady. Not now. Now I'm not going to be cheering. Now I'm not. Now it's the other way. Now I hope the season doesn't happen. I actually hope this NFL season doesn't happen. And I hate football kind of anyway, so fuck it. I hope the NFL season doesn't happen, you know, because after the fucking goddamn hockey season was ruined, my fucking Bruins were kicking ass, and now it sucks. I hope this fucking goddamn cocksucker.
Oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it.
Want some bubbly? Look at this stuff. Oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it.
Please, Joe, if you haven't seen this yet, it is the most savage political ad I have ever seen. About a week ago, Nancy Pelosi was being interviewed on a late night show and she showed off her freezer and chocolate ice cream. Video is called Nancy Antoinette.
What the fuck? I don't know if I can play it, though. Because it's probably got so many views.
I was going to say, if it was
$350 billion.
Oh, my God. Wait, this was put out by Donald Trump.
What?
Well, that should be safe then, right?
This is actually put out by Donald Trump.
Oh, I've seen one of these.
All right. I hate Nancy Pelosi, so this has got to be good, right?
I saw one about Biden.
It's got a lot of likes. Let's check this out. And Trump, if you do anything in my video, I will come after you with a full force.
Fund to help small businesses.
And I swear to God, you fucking orange fuck. You better leave it alone.
Workers get through the shutdown.
It will be up to Congress to restock it.
But Democrats blocking that move this morning.
They asked for $250 billion in 48 hours. I said, well, I don't think so. They objected, and I congratulate the Senate Democrats.
Speaker Pelosi, what are you going to share with us from your home?
Chocolate candy.
Thousands have been forced to wait for hours at food banks all across the country.
This is...
Oh my.
Chocolate, and then we have some other chocolate here. We just got to restock the ice cream.
You don't want to eat up everything all at one time.
I can't do it much longer. I'm trying so hard.
We're, shall we say, enjoying.
Having to admit that, yeah, we're starving, and
I like it better than anything else.
Taping this segment, there are 22 million people out.
This specific program is about stopping job losses today.
This is hurting people bad.
Other people in our family look for some other flavors, but
right now it's so.
I'm gonna look for some other flavors. Hey, everybody in February. Hey, everybody in February. Trump doesn't know how to handle COVID-19, but you know what? Come out to Chinatown and come visit with everybody.
Survival move. You don't know where that next something else is gonna come from.
I don't know what I would have done if ice cream were not invented. I just wonder.
Her face stuck.
That's pretty funny. She's a sick piece of shit. What a weird fuck she is.
I would like want to strangle myself just for coming from the same town as her.
Hmm. Yeah. I mean, this is the lady that, again, I listen. Like, I keep coming to this situation because if you want to bash Trump, that's cool. But put that over to the side. Put that over here. Because in February, Trump was doing stuff against the virus. And Nancy Pelosi was in the streets of San Francisco telling you to come visit San Francisco and Chinatown. Come on out to Chinatown in San Francisco and come meet everybody. It's nothing, like, whatever. It's not that big of a deal. And then in the same day, she says Trump doesn't know how to handle the virus. Like,
see,
well, how can you say that?
No one would give her shit about that if she didn't take the shots herself and right. Look like an idiot for doing it. Because let's be fair, in late January, early February, a lot of people were still trying to figure out what the fuck was going on. So for anyone to say that one person didn't know anybody, no one knew any fucking thing back in February.
Well, read my tweets in January.
Yeah. I mean, you could... you made some great points.
No, but even I didn't know. Like, even I was. I mean, right. Dude. But here's the thing: January 13th, I ordered masks. January 13th, I was ordering things. So I can't say that I knew it was going to be this bad, but I was worried based on what I saw in China. I was worried. And I was like, man, it's fucking weird out there. And you know what I started doing was I started washing my hands like we did back when, maybe when H1N1 or whatever that shit was happening was going on. I don't know. But
started
washing your
hands, period, or more?
But no, like after almost everything, kind of. Like after touching or like being out and things like that. Like sometimes I'd go out and, you know, I wouldn't think about it, you know, and maybe I'd wash my hands, but I wouldn't wash them like that. I wouldn't touch boxes from Amazon and then wash my hands. I was doing that in fucking January. You know what I mean? I've been doing this more and more as we go along. But the point is, Nancy Pelosi in late February said, come on out and hang out. It's all good. But then says that he doesn't know what he's talking about. And it's like, listen, that's fine. That may be true. And we can talk about that later. But you clearly super don't know what you're talking about. Like, so if he don't know what he's talking about, you don't know at all what you're talking about, or you do know what you're talking about and you're just trying to get everybody killed. I don't know.
On one hand, you got a person who says, don't worry about it, it's not that big of a deal. The other person is going completely the opposite direction and going, hey, come on out, it's a party.
Yeah, like, what the fuck?
It would be probably, if this shit's been multiplying like crazy, if this shit would be like, what, 10 times worse if we didn't act on it.
You know what I'd like to do? I'd like to act on one of her youngest fucking...
Oh.
What?
Yeah, I knew where that was going. I've been around way too long to know.
I know you're talking about me, bro. I know you're talking about me.
Don't worry, we'll get to you. We'll get to you eventually. We'll get to you eventually, JD. Don't worry. We're coming. We'll come get you. We'll come pick you up.
You got something for him?
No, I don't know. Oh. I'm just saying.
Like, oh, wow, I missed out on something here. What's this?
Yeah, I don't know.
Oh, you mentioned Kim Jong-un and whether he's dead or not dead or whatever. Did you hear that his sister got promoted just a few days ago before all this came out?
Whose sister?
Kim Jong-un's. Sister got promoted. She's the most powerful woman in North Korea.
So
it happened just a few days ago.
The hot chick, right? That everybody's always like yammering about.
Yeah.
Wow. That might
looks like Keiko O'Brien minus 30 pounds.
I mean, you know, this means that. I mean, he really is about to die. It feels like. It feels like he's about to die, man.
He went in for some sort of an operation or some sort of procedure on the 12th. He missed a dinner on the 15th, and then it was announced yesterday on the 20th that he was possibly on his deathbed. And somewhere in between the 12th and the 20th, she was promoted after receiving a demotion just a year ago, almost to the day.
Yeah, I mean...
So it's almost... It feels like they're staging her up for something, because even though they're not big on women being in charge, they're also not big on going outside of the family either. So where do you go with that, and how do you take that information?
I want to see his sister in a fucking... just a fuck-fest porn.
Like, Gronkowski, is that weird? And then she, like, slit his throat afterwards?
Yeah, man, she looks like a fucking... Like, she kind of looks like a skeleton. Like, she looks like she's got a skeleton-like face. You know, some people have that, like a skeleton-like face. But yeah, man, I want to see her in one of those just fuck fests. You know, where she just gets fucking lambasted. You know what
heard
I mean?
I've heard she's even more fucking diabolical than him.
I bet she is.
Like, she just wants to kill everybody.
I bet she is, yeah. See, I want to see her nostrils filled with cum.
Oh, my God, she couldn't get much wider.
Yeah, I mean, she's Asian, and she's also super white and super skeleton-like.
Fill out, Casey. Yeah. She's too thin for you by about 200 pounds, you know.
Fuck you, Drew.
Casey, you know, you could just sit on her face, like, and smash her fucking skull, like, with your asshole. You realize that?
She is way too fucking skinny, though.
You think so?
See, told you.
If she's like a damn skeleton, I don't like that shit. She has to have a little meat on her bones for me to like her. She don't have to be huge, but a lot more meat fucking than that.
Put a fucking Viking helmet on her head and she's Rita Repulsa.
She almost looks like a female Skeletor.
She looks like Winona Ryder on crack cocaine and cock. Which is almost Winona Ryder anyway. But yeah, she is she's from Skullfuckers Anonymous. Here comes Kane.
My name is Kane and I'm donating.
I hope the first thing that happens when the Gronk gets to Tampa is that he loses the 24/7 championship.
Wow. I mean, I think the 24 title, I mean, I think that thing's done. Heartland Newsfeed, what up?
Hopefully that shit sucks.
I swear to God, I think it might be done. Like, that's what Adam Ant was saying on Twitter, but he's been wrong about half of what he says. But, you know, but I wouldn't be surprised if they just brush that thing away right now. But really, they should be using the shit out of it, because they could use it for all kinds of backstage segments, like, constantly. So, you know, I don't know. I'd be
shit bomb
fucking using it.
Fuck you, Tommy J. Roberts, you fucking cunt.
Yeah, fuck you, Tommy J. Roberts, you fucking cunt. Mox, what's up, Mox? Mox MTG. Good to hear from you, man. Good to fucking hear from you.
Someone yelling at a Tommy that's not NC2010?
Yeah, it's a different Tommy.
Wow.
Someone's mad at a different Tommy. Mox, thanks for being a $5 shit bum.
I heard fuck you, Tommy, and I'm like, oh, here we go.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. I was like, oh, no, wait. No, it's not him. It's not him. It's about a different person. Unbelievable. That's crazy. But, yeah.
Gronk, I will cream pie your wife, motherfucker, then take back my belt, you retarded fuckface.
Oh, my God. Holy shit. R-Truth, thank you for the $3.50, R-Truth.
I'll tell you what, he's got a pretty hot-looking chick with him. Fucking Gronk does.
Well, R-Truth is pissed. That's a really pissed-off donation.
D. Welsh, North Korea confirmed he's fine. Oh, yeah, I'm sure they're confirming a lot with us.
Oh, yeah. He's doing good.
That's, you know, North Korea said it's fine, guys.
Yeah, no. North Korea says everything's okay, so it's gonna be fine. Everything's cool. No problem whatsoever.
It's gonna be the funniest fucking thing I've seen in that chat in weeks.
Right. That's fucked up, man. I'm just mad about Gronk, man. I want to throw him off a goddamn cliff.
He is signed with the Tampa Bay then.
Well, yeah. He was traded to them, yeah.
He was traded. I didn't know he could be traded, but he's traded.
I mean, they still hold his contract throughout, you know, so long of his retirement, I believe. Like, they still have to release him if he comes out of retirement.
Yeah.
And it was what? Was it a seventh-round draft pick that also went to the Bucks for a fourth-round conditional 2021 or some shit? I think that's what it was.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so they basically just got rid of him for a draft pick, which I guess, whatever, they didn't expect to have him anyways.
Yeah.
It's like, oh, this guy's retired that we didn't think we'd ever see again? Yeah, you want to give us a fourth-round draft pick? Yeah, sounds good.
Yeah, no shit.
God damn.
The Buccaneers anyways, you won't be able to do anything with him. I swear, the Buccaneers could have the all-NFL team. They could somehow find a way to get the best players in the NFL under the salary cap onto their team, and they'd find a way to fuck it up.
Yeah. They'd still fuck it up. And they're not going to do anything. It's just I wasn't mad before. Like, I was like, cool, Tom Brady, go get him. Like, you know, he took discounts for years in New England here. You know what I mean? So if they're not going to go out and get him some better fucking receivers and a better offensive line, because it was really garbage last year. I was angry last year. I was furious. So I got to imagine that he was pissed. Like, what the fuck are they doing? Like, are they trying to make me angry on purpose? Like, what is this? So you know, I was like, cool, man, good for him. I hope he does all right. And it's going to be weird to see him in a new uniform, but whatever. But now with Gronk going there, dude, now I'm enraged. Now I'm ready. Now I'm ready to see Gronk, you know, fucking fall down a flight of stairs and break his legs. I want to see Gronk impaled. I want to see a psycho mass murderer fucking run onto the field. And I don't know. I don't want to see Gronk. I don't know, man. I'm just fucking angry. I almost said something even more horrific than I said earlier. Like, I'm just fucking so pissed off right now about Gronk.
Everybody just kept pounding it in there.
Yeah.
Are you pissed off at Brady, though?
I don't know, man. I'm not sure who to be pissed off at. I'm not really pissed off at Brady, but I mean, like, I'm a little, I don't know. Like, I'm just slightly, I'm really fucking, I want to choke Gronk, man. I want to choke him and dig a grave. And then I want to pee in his eyes. And, like, I want his eyes to be pissed on.
If I were in your shoes, I'd be upset to see Tom Brady leave. But it's kind of hard to be mad at a guy that took you guys to the promised land for damn near 20 years.
Yeah, right. No shit.
Right. You're 43 years old or whatever, and you want to, you know, go play fucking Bush League with the Buccaneers and whatever. Thanks for your time.
Well, how long did you Brady sign a contract with the Bucs?
I don't know his contract details. It's probably only a year or two, I would imagine. Do you know, Joe?
You figured this...
his contract? I don't know. I can't imagine it's more than one or two.
I don't think he wanted a real long contract. I mean, who's going to give it to him, to be fair?
No shit. How
especially
old
if it's front-loaded.
Yeah, I can't imagine it would be that crazy.
Who's going to give him a front-loaded contract either? So that, you know.
No one.
No one's that dumb. 2-year contract worth $50 billion guaranteed money with up to $4.5 million each year in incentives.
Jesus.
Out of him, at least. But you can opt out of a contract after one. In the NFL, so he's only really held to one season. A season that may not even happen.
And well, I hope it doesn't.
Well, they'll probably hold that contract. They'll probably pull like a WWE thing where they'll freeze that contract.
That you can. Is it two playable seasons or two, like, we've never had a season get canceled in the NFL that I can recall.
No, not at all.
So I don't know what kind of contingency plan they might have for that if, like, an entire season was scrapped. Does the contracts push another year? Do they get out of that year?
He gets COVID and then can't play for, like, 7 weeks. That could happen.
Just start.
What else we got? Oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it. That's
want
it.
Some bubbly? Look at this stuff. Oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it.
Lex Luger.
I missed the Raw review last night, but Zelina Vega was looking like a snack. It's hard to jerk off in wheelchair, but damn, she got me too. Play my music, Joe.
Damn, man. Yeah, man. Holy shit. Zelina Vega was looking like, I mean, it was time to gobble some puss, Lex Luger. It was time to gobble some puss last night, dude.
But often she looks bad, though. She's usually looking pretty good anytime she's out there that I see.
Right.
I agree about that.
Hard for her to look bad. I bet you she wakes up first thing out of bed, no makeup on, and still fucking drop a load in her.
It goes right in her ass.
Hey, wherever she wants it, man.
Hold on.
Go.
How's your wife been doing? How's Tara doing? How's her feeling? She feeling good?
Yeah, no, she's been doing good. I, you know, helped her out a couple days ago, if you know what I mean. But she is overwhelmed with work right now. Mm. She started about 7 in the morning, and she's still up there fucking going to town on her projects.
Dr. Earl. What up, Dr. Earl? Jump on over here if you want to be on, Dr. Earl. You got to jump in the hold.
I got a quick question. Drew, you're talking about this whole thing about passing the coronavirus through a fart. Does this mean you shouldn't be eating ass right now?
I mean, hey, you take your risks where you want, right?
So how did you catch COVID? I was like, I ate some girl's ass a whole out.
You want to eat some ass? Is that what you're saying?
No, I'm saying, imagine, I guess you have to be safe eating ass now.
Oh, yeah, you got to be, yeah, you don't want to be munching on ass. Especially some random person or something like that. You definitely don't want to do that.
That's what I'm saying, because you might get corona through eating the asshole out.
What the
fuck?
To
be fair, just about anywhere you're going to get it on the human body.
How much asshole actually, are you eating out?
I mean, Casey must be eating a lot. He's the one who brought it up. He's really concerned about it.
Yeah, Casey, that's kind of nasty, bro. I mean, what's going on here?
Ass as he eats out, though, his face actually disappears into the ass.
Right.
True. It's fucked up.
Fucking Bertha, you know, any normal size head could get stuck in there, but yours, Jesus.
Yeah, he's just sticking his head up in there. So it's the ass chunks, right? It's like the fecal matter chunks that we're really concerned about, right, over everything else.
Right, I mean, if you want to be serious for a second, if you're walking through somewhere, the store or whatever, and you smell a fart, you're not going to get it unless someone's walking around with their pants down or something. It's the fact that, because your pants are going to stop it. It's
right.
The shit that comes out of it that can affect you. And it's only in 50% of people that were tested with coronavirus. So
yeah.
You got a 50-50 chance of even surviving the fart if they do fucking, you know, teabag and go to town.
Yeah, now I had fucking heard that that this shit, you know, this really potent and shit, you know, like that's a major issue.
I mean, 50%. I mean, what's the detection in saliva? Is it 100%? Is it 80? I've never heard a number. How certainly are you going to get it if you take in saliva from someone else?
I assume it's got to be really high.
You would think, but I mean, there was a cruise ship out there a few months ago that when it came back 3-4 weeks, it was left quarantined out in the water. And when it came back, only 2/3 of the ship had it.
Right.
So, I mean, if it's that contagious, then why didn't it come back with 100% infections?
That's a good point.
You're not hiding from anybody on a fucking cruise ship.
Yeah. Yeah, you don't know what the hell's going to happen. Do you think... Man, I don't know, dude. I wonder if the NFL season's even going to start on time, you know? Probably not.
I mean,
they canceled school finally here, by the way. I mean, I knew that was going to happen.
At this point, yeah.
I mean, it's possible. Right. I mean, shit, the regular season starts in September.
I mean, preseason starts right at the beginning of August, maybe late July.
Yeah.
And then, you know... I mean, unless all these cities and states open up, it turns out to be too early and it all starts up again and is worse than it was before or something. I mean, that's entirely possible.
Yeah.
Yeah, it'll be twice as bad. The quarantine will be twice as long and.
Shit.
And everybody actually dies this time.
No, that's what happened with the Spanish flu. So.
Dude,
is that Philadelphia where that parade was that you were talking about?
Yeah, they opened all that shit up, and then it got worse. Because they were like, oh, yay. It's literally the exact fucking thing of like, oh, here's 30 pills of, you know, whatever the fuck, antibiotics. And you take 5, start feeling better, and you're like, ah, I don't need the rest of these. And then you get sick again. It's like, dude, you're going to need to fucking, need to take all this shit.
What do you think the point is that people start? Is it 100% gone? Is that where we finally do it? Do we wait years and years and years until everyone is, until the whole thing's eradicated? Or is it 50%? Is it 80%? Is it now? I mean, what's the benchmark? What do you think it is?
For what number?
You know, people that don't have it anymore, like the number's going down. How far do they need to go down? 50%, 80%, 100% before we open the country back up? Does it need to be completely eradicated?
Yeah, you need to see that scale drop way, way down.
Not all the way to zero.
No. But I mean,
I don't think we'll ever see zero.
As long as there's a line of like, hey, listen, if we start reaching this line again, we're going to do this again. And then you probably know where the line is. We're probably right at the line. We probably reached, I mean, New York certainly did. But, you know, nowhere else really reached that line, although it's busy. I would say most everywhere else is really busy right now, and it's really a pain in the ass. But New York was crazy, but it didn't get as crazy as it could have. So, but it still could, so you just got to be careful, you know.
That's what I'm saying. But if it's as highly contagious as everyone's saying, shouldn't we wait till it hits zero? But then again, under the air quote quarantine that we're under, it's never going to hit zero.
No, because, well, but here's the thing. Like, so many people right now, at this point, so many people are going to have gotten it and not known it. And then a ton of people are going to have gotten it and known it. And then a ton of people are going to, you know, then a good amount of people are going to be, you know, critical from it. But so, but the point is there's a whole shitload of people. Like, probably by September, probably 40% of our whole country has had it. Like, seriously.
Whether they do it or not, right?
Right. Like, for real. You know, every time they test groups of people, they find out, like, fucking 40% of them had it. And those people are like, I don't remember. I didn't get anything. I don't even know. What the fuck?
So, well, I mean, I said this before. For all we know, when I was sick over Super Bowl, that could have been it. I could have had it then with as much as I travel around.
Yeah. Yeah, maybe you had it. Maybe you had
maybe
it.
Maybe on the reason it's in Kansas.
Well, you know, maybe you brought it to Rhode Island, you cunt. You fucking asshole piece of shit.
What, a year ago?
Yeah, what kind of piece of shit are you? You brought it to fucking goddamn Rhode Island, you asshole fuckface.
Hold on, did he pass it to you, Joe, when he gave you the blowjob?
You know what, Casey? I'm not even going to answer that, you fucking goddamn fucking Corona snacking cunt.
What else we got? Oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it.
Want some bubbly? Look at this stuff. Oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it.
Yikes.
She looks like an Asian version of Charlotte Gainsbourg. Joe, did you hear about Corona-chan wrecking Patreon and Kickstarter?
Corona-chan wrecking Patreon and Kickstarter. Who's Corona-chan? Bimbo Baggins, thanks for the $3, man. Who's
you to Patreon?
Who's Corona-chan? What are you talking about? I don't know who that is. Somebody figure
out. I haven't seen any emails or
Corona-chan.
What else we got? Oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it. That's
Want
it.
Some bubbly? Look at this stuff. Oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it.
Drew, if you noticed a cum stain on the bathroom wall, it's mine.
Oh.
And tell Tara me and my homie Andre will be back next weekend.
You guys are really sneaky, you know, because I've been in this fucking house for a month, so I'd like to know how you're pulling that off.
That was N-word named Tyrone.
Oh, anyway, I saw a video of him walking up to an apartment complex pretending to be a cop. I think Costanza found that one.
That guy is...
Dude was pissed.
That guy's plunging into your wife, Drew. I don't know if you can take this shit.
What else we got? Oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it.
Here comes
Want some bubbly? Look at this stuff. Oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it.
I swear to the Almighty, if Gronk had CTE and killed his own family and himself, I will party harder when the Patriots defeated the Rams.
Oh my God, if Gronk had CTE and killed his own family and himself, I would party. What the fuck, twat? Oh my God, I do hope that Rob Gronkowski's first kid is stillborn. I will say that. I'm not going to back off of that statement. I know there's a lot of people like, that's fucked up.
That make up for everything?
No, it doesn't make up. No, and nothing will ever make up for it, but
okay.
I hope it comes out fucking... See, you know what's funny is that even sounds like Chris Benoit's music, but like sped up wicked fast.
So sound like to me. That's what I thought it was.
No, that's Stillborn by Black Label Society.
I have to hear it again.
How did I not know that song?
That's Stillborn by Black Label Society, and it sounds like Chris Benoit's song sped way up.
Yeah, a little bit.
Yeah, I mean, think about that.
He's gonna be pissed off.
Yeah.
It sounds like it if you sped it way up.
It's a pretty common riff, though. So.
Yeah.
Country Fair.
I'm like it now. Just... now mention it.
Still born. You can almost do it. Fucking telling you, man, I solved something here. Gronkowski is going to kill his family. This is some kind of sign from God. Holy shit, Gronkowski is going to kill his fucking family, everybody.
First, he's got to come out of the closet and admit that him and Mojo Rawley have bump-pumped each other.
Yeah, exactly right, yeah. Jesus Christ, someone's got to figure this out. We got to, I mean, somebody has to fucking go scan his brain now. Go figure this shit out.
Just cut into it. He'll be fine. If anything else, we can send him on a spaceship to Proxima C.
Oh, God.
Well, how many of these football players do you think actually has?
Oh?
How many of what?
How many of these football players...
Jesus.
Can you hear me?
Barely. It sounds like you.
Jesus Christ.
It sounds like you're under a fucking bathtub.
Can you hear me now?
Yes.
You can.
Okay. I was wondering how many of these football players have CTE.
Well, how the fuck do I know?
No, I'm just curious.
You gotta cut into their head to find out. Or wait till they shoot themselves in the chest.
Yeah.
Like the fucking dumbass Seau.
Junior Seau themselves. Then we'll know.
Too much of a pussy to shoot himself in the head. I wish he would have survived that. Just for being a dumb shit.
Imagine him waking up in the hospital.
Did work.
Oh, no. Oh, no. You know when someone tries to kill themselves, but it doesn't work out the right way? And then they wake up in the fucking hospital. That's the, like, there should be a fucking TV show for that. Hey, somebody, is any Hollywood producers out there? I would love to be the guy who hosts a TV show about suicide, but only the suicides that don't work. And we would call it Failed Suicide 911 or like botched suicide. It would be called Botched Suicide. It would start out like intense, like, every year. More than 100,000 people attempt their own lives in America alone. Dun, 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 dun. They don't always get the job done. Dun, 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 dun. That's where we come in. Dun, 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 dun. And then it starts off like, and it's just a compilation like constantly, and the guy and all of the episodes start with the person realizing that they're not dead when they wanted to be dead, and so like it's a lot of them start like this with the guy in the hospital bed. Christopher Jenkins, a 26-year-old male recently fired from his job, apparently attempted to take his life by shooting himself in the chest after ingesting formaldehyde. However, the neighbors heard the bang and called the police, and Christopher's been in intensive care for 3 weeks. He's now starting to come to. And it looks
Connors,
like
a weatherman from Pittsburgh.
He's like this. He's like this.
Go find a groundhog.
He's like this.
And then he couldn't kill himself.
Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. And then the doctor's like, "Sir, you've been through a horrific event. We were able to get your pulse back and we honestly think you're going to make a full recovery, son. Are you feeling any pain right now?" No! Oh my god, dude. And then that's the fucking show. And they follow the guy for another, like.
Yeah, so you gotta have Phil Connors play a cameo in that. Have Bill Murray do a cameo spot as Phil Connors. And.
Oh my God!
Fucking man, get up!
Yeah, Bill Murray.
Fucking groundhog.
At the end of every episode, a celebrity shows up to cheer them up, and like they know it, they're like, "I ate my life. Why am I here?" And then like they're like, the guy comes in, tells them, "Hey, listen, we've been filming your whole thing. You wait a minute. You mean I'm on Failed Suicide? Yeah, you're on Failed Suicide. Oh my God, I watch this show all the time. I mean, my mother's gonna see this. Yes, she is. No, like, oh my God. Well, but what does that mean? I'm gonna meet a celebrity? It does. And in fact, here he is, Bill Murray. Like, yeah, like, hey, kid.
On Burgundy.
How you doing? Oh, but yeah, we looked on your Facebook and we saw you were a big fan of Ron Burgundy, played by Will Ferrell. Oh yeah, yeah, I love that. What did you guys bring me the movie to watch? I haven't seen a movie in a while. I heard I've been in a coma for like 7 weeks. Well, we didn't just bring you the movie. We actually brought you Ron Burgundy. And he just comes in and has balloons.
I got the perfect name for this. Make a wish for dipshits. Like, make a wish to bring the fucking celebrities in, but instead they come in and tell you how much of a fucking retard are you for missing your heart.
Welcome back to Botched Suicide. Last week we were following two patients, Rob and Jane McLemore, who tried to, like, it's like, oh my God, you know this would be a show. Like, you know this could be a show. Like, MTV would make this a show. So, like, you know, and I know it sounds sick.
Else.
I'm telling you, man, this would happen. It's actually kind of amazing this did not happen already.
You got to copyright all the names you can think of, Joe. So,
yeah,
they don't steal the idea.
No, fuck them. They can have it.
You could get at least a miniseries out of the JCS community alone.
Yeah, My Failed Suicide. There's so many names. There's a million names you can come up with. Like, Botched Suicide, My Failed Suicide. There's literally a million of them. Mommy, what the hell is going? Why are you? What the hell is going on? What did you do? Go upstairs. I'm doing stuff. I'm doing work. I don't. Go upstairs. Go upstairs. God damn it, man. I don't know why my daughter just came down here soaked in water. Said mummy did it.
On this week's episode of JCS Failed Suicide, we've flown all the way out to Abu Dhabi. No, I'm kidding.
Oh. Oh, my God.
I'm sorry. I love you, man.
Wow. I mean, that's not funny, Drew. That's fucked. That's not cool. You should kill yourself.
Why? So I can be on the next episode?
Oh, what did the fag say to the other fag? Gobble my cock. You fuck. Frog off. Hello! Belly, you cunt. Hello! 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 Frog off. Hello! Hello! Belly, you cunt.
I can't believe you said that.
I didn't say it was him.
God damn it.
There's probably most people watching.
Oh my God.
Gronk, you bastard. Crying face.
Jesus. My son Champ. What's up, Champ? Gronk, I'm coming for you, Gronk. I swear to God, dude. I'm going to chop your legs off, Gronkowski. I am going to chop your legs off, you fucking idiot, drunken asshole. I'm going to come out of retirement now. Could have won a Super Bowl last year, you idiot. God damn it. I hope he gets an automobile accident. I hope Gronkowski gets in a fucking automobile accident. I hope he gets lupus. Ah! Sorry. Oh. Jesus.
Drew and Joe Cronin draft to the Pats. We always get it done.
My son champion. Thank you, my son champ. That's two back-to-back in a row. Yeah, I think we would do a better job than what they did last year. You know?
Give me a wide receiver.
You know, WWE's tweeting about the 24/7 title and stuff, so maybe it's not gone. Like, they're tweeting about this, like, hey, maybe Gronk will lose it to Tom Brady.
Like they said that they were listening to the show. They stole our idea.
You think so?
Fuckers. Yeah, well, I just said it 20 minutes ago.
Well, I don't know when this tweet is from, though. This tweet might be old. It could be an old tweet.
Oh, we know they listen to every show. They even listen if you have 12 viewers.
Yeah, you're right. They even listen to autistic people with 12 viewers.
They're listening to us. They're listening right now to us. You know that?
Oh, my God. I can't get enough of that shit.
WWE listens to me. WWE listens to me. They really watch everything I do. You know, WWE listens to us, and they've stolen several ideas here from me. I'm Chris. They've stolen my ideas. All 8 of my listeners in the audience, they stole my ideas. So this is weird that it's happened. It's really shameful of WWE, because they're really jealous of what we're doing here. They're jealous of what we have here. So they steal my ideas. Why do they steal my ideas? Do you know why, Drew, that they steal my ideas?
Because they're retarded?
I'm retarded. I have YouTube. I took all of my donations from Joe. Same amounts. Same names. Everyone does it. You know that? What do you mean? This is ridiculous. WWE steals all my ideas.
It would be funny as if they stole all his ideas, but it were all the shitty ones that they've done in the last 4 or 5 years. All the things that everyone just hated and despised. And
that would be pretty funny. That would be actually pretty
funny. Yeah, it makes sense. And it's funny. Quick. And they're putting themselves in the ground over a guy with two
just
subs.
To show you guys what happened. Here it is.
Or take a knife and slash the Bailey Buddies. Fucking, jeez. So he's banned. I banned him already. He's a fucking douchebag. And now he's gonna bring in his fucking friends from other channels. Oh, please unban him and fuck you, man. You want come in here and talk wrestling? Don't be a douchebag. You're fucking so far up that other douchebag's asshole. And
that's he's talking about me right there, by the way.
That's what that other douchebag says. And the fact is, guess what? We proved you wrong, motherfucking douchebag, again, time after time.
You know what would be a great idea? Yeah. Let's put the title on a towel head.
By the way, that's like six. That's like, ah. Oh, my God. Dude, that's like 6 months ago where he's like flipping out over me. But yet he's only watched the show for 1 hour. Remember that?
Half years. Of course I have some connections into the pro wrestling industry after 2.5 years.
Should've... Yeah, of course I have connections to the pro wrestling industry. I have connections to the pro wrestling industry. I've only, I just because I do this dumb show, somehow I have connections, you know? It's crazy.
What would be a great idea if we rolled an 8-year-old kid out into WrestleMania and put the tag titles on him and Braun Strowman?
Just jealous. That would just, you're just jealous.
They would have so many people watching.
Yeah, I really like Scott and Joe Killed. I mean, I don't know who they are.
Go fuck yourself, because you fucking suck, and you wish it was you. I wish it was me. It should have been me. It's the fucking Peep Show on YouTube. So fuck you. We're not going to push this fake freaking agenda of stupid other YouTubers talking shit, making up their own things. Listen, the facts are there. If you don't see it in front of you, then it is what it is. So
I don't know the facts.
We've been doing this for 2.5 years. Of course I have some connections into the pro wrestling industry after 2.5 years. That's what happened.
And I've got contacts in the national media, Peeper, all right?
Oh, my God.
That's when you do it for 2.5 years. You haven't even been doing it for a minute, bro. You're fucking... Jeez. So, he's banned. I banned him already. Yeah.
He's talking about Dave 25. He's mad at Dave 25 there.
Oh, really?
He's a fucking douchebag.
That explains why he's going off in the
channel. And now he's going to bring in his fucking friends from other channels. Oh, please unban him and fuck... Fuck you, man. You want come in here and talk wrestling. Don't be a douchebag. You're fucking so far up that other douchebag's asshole, and that's what that other douchebag says. And the fact is, guess what? We proved you wrong, motherfucking douchebag, again, time after time. Oh, they think WWE is listening to us, blah, blah, blah. Well, guess what? They fucking are, because we're a real pro wrestling show, even though we haven't even done a breakdown yet. But, yeah, I would
fucking piping it in a mouth like
I love cock. I love.
Well, this time I've been following news. I, you know, I've got an actual 8 o'clock appointment with Connie Chung tomorrow night. We're gonna
Oh, you got a cornhole?
Each other up. Yeah, we're gonna fill each other up.
Oh, I can't. I'm ready for that, bro. I'm ready.
Hey, you know, after 2 years of doing shit, you got contacts, man. And and I'm starting with Connie Chung, and before long, it's gonna be that whore on CNBC.
Connie Chung. Well, it's because a lot of the people
more up front.
I mean, listen,
she just
eat that tushy.
We know, me and
so, you know, this isn't a bad thing to finally, I guess, it's been a long time, is what I'm trying to say.
I think it was guy after you're doing it for the kid, be a day shoe thing. I never get a strike.
I mean, he says to Tommy, well, Joe,
to watch it that much, and everything. Oh, yeah. So then I did reach out to you. I don't know if you remember, I sent you an invitation.
Minions, but you do, and you don't understand that you're doing it, but you do.
Oh, right. You're... No, somebody's lying about you. Joe's a scumbag.
Like I said, right.
But here's the thing. I'm friends with Tommy, Chris. Like, I don't know if you know that. I talk with him off the air. Like, we're, like, really friends.
Yeah, I bear, like I said, as far as is me watching, it's not as much as you think or said. I don't know.
I agree. Okay, I can agree with that. That maybe you only watch for a little while for a short time, and that was it.
And I don't know. People know bring it out here. So back to the thing was, I'm like, oh, this guy, you know, he's gonna support smaller streamers, not shit on him and shit. I'm like, that's pretty cool. Maybe fucking maybe he, you know, something could happen. I mean, so then I did reach out to you. I don't know if you remember. I sent you an invitation to my first year anniversary or something show.
Yeah, I do remember talking to you because I wanted to do something with you, yeah. Or I was going to do something with you.
And then, you know, you never replied or showed up, so I was kind of like, well, that's kind of fucked up.
Well, I want you to know that that's not because I was like, fuck this guy. It was literally just I just missed it. I can't tell you how many times I miss shit with people. I got a guy that we've been trying to do. It's always like this saltiness from people that gets people to talk shit. You know? Podcast for 5 months and haven't hooked up. And Dave... a cunt, and I've been like, well, fuck him. What a
dick. Me, you watch like minutes, maybe you watch
your show a little bit. I didn't have the time to watch.
Problem with you, and I haven't. We already knew that this guy was in the fucking chats for like months, and he's like, I only seen Joe for an hour, so I've never seen his show for more than an hour. Yet he knows all my co-hosts and knows everybody. It was so fucking funny. I love it for a while.
Yeah, I just wanted to just clear up that. I mean, yeah, obviously I watched the show a little bit. I didn't have the time to watch it that much, and I wasn't active or whatever.
Like you said earlier to me, Chris Beats, you said you watched them for like minutes, maybe one stream. Is that true?
I don't want to fucking like bury Joe.
I mean, but earlier, Chris Beats, you told me you watched like minutes of one stream of Joe Cronin.
Well,
is
I mean, the live chats will tell you otherwise on that right away. But whatever.
Chris Beats, let's go ahead and be honest. Let's go.
I'm being honest. You could go back to live chats. Between
so you literally watched one stream of Joe Cronin in your life.
No, minutes. I told you what I said earlier is I said probably a combined 3 or 4 shows I watched, and I only watched fucking maybe 10 minutes, 15 minutes, one show.
See, I remember so you. I remember you. I remember you in the chat a lot more than that.
That's not true whatsoever, man.
All right, well, I'll agree with it. I don't remember that.
I mean,
well.
Whatever. It's fucking. I would say maybe I've watched a total hour of your show back in the day, and I haven't really watched. No offense, I haven't watched it really since because of everything.
Then
and
how do you know about all the stuff with Tommy?
Well, the thing with Tommy was, it must have been like monetize this or something. I might have watched a couple minutes, and I just seen
see
everyone.
Listen, Chris, I like you, but this is complete bullshit.
I gotta agree, bro. It sounds like you're spewing some bullshit.
I appreciate you. I do like you. I have no problem with you, but this is bullshit. And there's multiple community members, even a couple guys who like Steven Gurman, who watched you and me. And he he knows like that. What's the truth?
What are you saying is the truth then? And I'll clear it up.
Well, I mean, I'm just saying, like, you know, I saw you around for kind of months. It seemed like.
No, you didn't.
What show were you concerned about with Tommy? A monetized this episode?
It must have been just one show I seen of him, and everyone was ripping on the poor guy.
Hold on, Chris. Like, you told me earlier that you only watched like 5-10 minutes of Joe Crone, and now all of a sudden you're watching monetized this too? Where's this coming from?
Well, I said I watched a couple.
Chris,
of
stop, man. Just stop, bro.
Oh, please.
It's okay, bro. Listen, I like you. Just, it's all good, man.
But like
that, we're not here to hate you, bro. We're here to be fucking cool with you, bro. Like seriously, I appreciate your call, but stop lying, dude.
I wasn't part of the community. I wasn't watching. Yeah, I might have showed up a couple times.
How did you? How did you ever hear about Scott?
I didn't when he trolled me. Never heard of Scott before until he trolled me.
How did you ever hear about? Wait a minute. Pause, Scott. How did you ever hear about Ken?
I have no probably through maybe through you. I don't fucking know.
Oh, so you heard about him through me too on a different show or on another 5 minutes you heard?
I don't even remember where.
Oh,
I
shit. Oh shit, dude.
No, tell me how if I was watching that much how I didn't know who Scott was.
I
don't know, you know, the other people.
How do I know? Because really... Scott's not on every single show. Like you may not know who he is. He was actually right about that one. I might believe that one, but he's also been trolled by the guy for a while. So I might have believed that one, but still, the guy knew about everybody. He knew about every show, every person. He knows who Troy is. He referenced him before. He's referenced almost every character on my show that's ever been on my show, and every person that's ever been on the show.
I remember 3 years ago talking to the guy in the chat, and I didn't know him from Adam back then. He was just another guy in the chat, you know, because I was pretty active in the chat myself back then.
Right,
but. When I first heard about what he does on YouTube, I was like, oh, that's that guy from the chat. I wish I would have mentioned that Friday night, but I don't know if I didn't get a chance to or what. I wanted to mention it though. It's like, how do I know that you're the dude from the chat if you only spent an hour here?
My favorite thing is where he says he only watched my show for an hour, but he knows every co-host. He knows Tommy. He even told Tommy to stop doing stuff with me to do it with him instead, which is everyone does that about Tommy. Everyone, ever since Tommy's appeared on my show, every dickhead person I've ever known who's a co-host of mine has tried to suck Tommy off to bring them onto their show. But this guy was like, oh, I only know him for an hour. Then he went on to bashing me and saying, like, what kind of guy calls himself a god and everything like that. And I'm like, okay, so he knows about that. He even knows about that little joke of me saying that I'm God and stuff like that. Obviously, it's a fucking joke or whatever. But he even knows about that, so he knows about that. But I know that I don't need to prove this to myself. I already know. I saw the guy in the chat for like a year. He was here for a long time. But it's him saying this to other people, and other people are like, yeah, that Joe's really pathetic. Joe's a pathetic scumbag. He really is, yeah. And then this guy goes, and another thing about Joe, and it's like, well, how do you know all this about me if you've only watched 1 hour? And here he is.
Another one right there, Derek Hansen in the chat. He's confirming what I said, that the dude was in the chat long enough for him to go, hey, I remember that name.
And he's actually bashing me in that clip earlier that we played. Like, go to that other guy, whatever the hell. Like, he's obviously got this major vendetta thing. Like, it's weird. Like, this is old news, by the way. This guy's been doing this for about 2 years now. He's been doing this for 2 years. But I never talk about him at all. I only talked about him now. Because he went and said this stuff to Scott, and even went to other people to talk shit about me. But, you know, because people who don't like me will give platforms to anybody who will bash me. So they give a platform to this idiot. And even Tennis Racket Jones. We played this last week. Tennis Racket Jones made a song fucking about my show and even bashed this guy. Why would Tennis Racket Jones, a random listener... who came up with his own lyrics to some rap song about riding my dick. Why would he make a song with this guy in it? It's because everybody in the community knew the guy, what he was doing. He was coming into my chat and being like, come on, into my stream instead of Joe. It's like, listen to this. You got the same mic and setup. Stop riding his dick. You got the same Skype setup. Who you trying to kid? Get your own fucking gimmick, intellectual property. You're trying to pass Joe like he's going Monopoly. You want me making 200 bucks? You're getting fucked by the long cock and tennis racket Joe. Come fuck with me. Taking your take and you never give it back. Sitting hitting on the same six women in the chat. I lay you a ride and I'm Cronin's dick. Shit. Chris Peeps is about as real as a spray tan. Face looking like it's grazed by a rape van. So why would Tennis Racket Jones make this song on his own? In 2018. That song was made in 2018 on September.
Wow.
So it's just hilarious.
2 years now.
Really funny. And
you know what was the biggest thing you brought up earlier? You know, you're right. Scott is not on any of your shows that often.
Yeah, that's very why he didn't know who he was. Like, I could see him not knowing who he was. Yeah, because he's had moments and stuff like that, but you're right. He's not like a co-host or something.
Yeah.
But yeah, just what a weird thing. And somebody brought it up again earlier, so I figured, let's throw down on that shit, bro.
You can screenshot the chat right now. Derek Hans, Broken Lion, the Bep, they're all saying he was in the chat all the fucking time, promoting his shit, and yeah, I mean,
he was a regular guy.
I'm not the only one.
He was a regular fixture.
Yeah, like you said, Tennis Racket Jones, if he's here every episode, he's not in the chat, but even he picked up on it. And he's not in the chat that often. Even if he is listening, he's not always in the chat. And, come on, dude. Exposed.
Yeah, it's just, this one was an easy one.
I was going to say, he made it way too easy.
Like, this was a layup. I don't even know why he would lie about these things. Like, that's what I'm confused about. Why would
the stretches before the game?
Why would you even lie about these things? You know? You know,
I don't know, to try and keep his credibility with his 12 viewers, like maybe.
What?
It's hard to gain him back after 2.5 years of growing a business where you've got a lot of contacts in the industry. You know.
Yeah, after 2.5 years, you gotta have contacts.
Yeah.
Actually, Robert Stack comes to me in my dreams after some of the unsolved mysteries I cracked back in the day. I mean, that's how heavy my contacts are.
Jesus. You know what I'd like to do is I'd like to get Rob Gronkowski and fucking Chris in a fucking little room together and let them beat themselves to death with steel dildos. That's what I'd like to see. Bloody dildo fight with these two fucking mongoloids.
Give me a hell yeah! Joe, did you see Leafy threatening to make another video on Tommy today on Twitter? What's up, Drew?
What is up? Suburban Cowboy. Yeah, he was kidding, Suburban Cowboy. I'm pretty sure.
I didn't even see it. Well, I don't follow the guy, so I want to know.
Yeah, I mean, the whole Leafy thing with Tommy back in the day was... I helped Tommy get 1 million subs, and then he stabbed me in the back. So I don't talk about it that much anymore. Because that was retarded. You know, imagine if I could go back in time and not tell Tommy about what to do in that video, and he never made that video, like, and he probably would have, like, just gone under the rug, you know?
Probably.
Yeah, at least Levy's been trolling everybody. He's just making shit up, you know? I think he said something like he's going to do a 3-hour video on Tommy as his last video or something. I don't know. I don't even know if that's. It's like his new tweet. It's like his new tweet too. But it's. He's just fucking around, man. The guy's fucking.
It's weird that he would even bring it up, though. Why would he? Why, out of all the things he's done, would he bring that up?
It's not real. He's not going to do it. You know what I mean?
He would even reference it.
I'm sure Tommy's going to use this for like. Tommy's going to milk it for, like, whatever, like, for attention from everything. You know, I'm sure other people are going to use it to exploit Tommy. I'm sure people will exploit Tommy to try to get some kind of clout off of whatever. But whatever.
Guarantee you there's already a DM in Keemstar's box.
Yeah, it's pathetic, man. The guy fucking did this to you fucking 4 years ago. I made videos ranting on Leafy, bashing him. I got death threats for weeks. I was under an attack. And then when the chips were down, Tommy turned his back on me. When I'm the one who told him to make that fucking video of himself crying, acting like he was going to kill himself. And he does it. And you know what? And you know what, man? If people keep fucking with me, you know, and if Tommy fucks with me, man, if people want to keep fucking with me, I have all the fucking goddamn evidence that I need to fuck people over. I got the fucking voice messages with me. I got the voice messages with Tommy C. I got the voice messages with Tommy NC. I got the voice messages with the videos that Keemstar and Leafy did. So let's play. Let's dance, bro. If you want to play the game, man, I fucking help you out, and then I get shit on. I helped out Tommy, and I get shit on. If you want to shit on me again, brother, I'll release a video that will fucking blow the world apart. Motherfucker, I'll release a goddamn video that will tear the fucking universe apart. Motherfucker. Wait till someone, like, I'm telling you what, if Keemstar fucking knew what I had, this fucking guy would be calling my personal cell phone. If Keemstar knew what I had recorded, and Keemstar knew about the truth of everything, motherfucking Keemstar would be fucking jerking me off. He'd be jerking my dick off. All over the place. It'd be like a fucking cum bath. It'd be a fucking cum bath, motherfucker. We'll see what happens, man. We'll see how it goes. Don't make Joe do it. Don't make Joe do it.
Oh. Awkward silence. Yeah. Casey, what was the last fat bitch you fucked?
I can't answer that.
Oh. Okay.
Scarce so wasn't
too
bad.
Many to count.
Because
huh?
If I answer that, I might get in trouble.
Mm. Oh, wow.
What?
Are you calling her fat? Are you calling her fat?
Who?
I'm not saying.
I didn't say
current.
Anything. No, no.
I thought you were insinuating that your current girl was fat.
That's what I'm saying. It's like,
error. Yeah. Crazy error.
Wait, what girl are we talking about?
I just asked him who the last fat bitch was he fucked. And he's like, I can't answer that right now. I might get in trouble. I'm thinking he's insinuating his current chick.
Are you saying that she's listening to this?
No comment. I don't.
Oh my god! You should.
I don't want to get in.
You're already in trouble, bro.
Yeah, I got news for you.
How did I get in trouble? All I said was no comment. It could be anyone.
Oh no! I'm telling you, man.
Hold on. Because if I say it's my current girlfriend, I can't say that or my late wife.
Oh. Oh, hey, you're smarter than really... Tommy because you actually figured out the irony of that question. So good for you on that, but you already backed yourself into the corner.
You are in some trouble.
That was a lose-lose question.
You're in some trouble, bro. You are in some trouble. Like, you're gonna be in the shit now.
I'm just glad she ain't here tonight.
She won't be for a while after that.
But is she watching? Is she watching the show? Is that why you're scared about it?
I think there's potential she might. There's some potential. She told me she has.
Yeah. Wait a minute. Your girl has potential for what? Like getting fucking fucked? I mean, what are you talking about?
No, potentially watch the show.
Oh, okay. I see. All right. I see what you're saying.
So that's why I'm just walking a fine line. I'm not saying my girlfriend's fat, but I'm just saying, I did play this full round after when my late wife passed.
Yeah.
And my current girlfriend.
Do you ever, are you ever having sex with your current girlfriend? Like, and maybe close your eyes and picture, you know, your old, the, your ex, your wife.
No.
No, you never pictured her? Like, let me just try to.
No, that'd be kind of, that'd be weird.
That is weird. But I'm just, you know, I could see somebody doing it, you know? I don't know what that's like.
You know, I mean, have you ever pictured anyone else when you're having sex?
Not really, but, like, I don't know. But, like, what if I lost my wife, you know, of so many years, and I was banging some new girl, and I don't know, every once in a while it might slip in, like, you know? Let me just pretend.
I have called her the wrong name when I first dated her.
When you're first,
I'll say, yeah.
When you're first mating with her, you called her the wrong name.
No, it was before we hooked up the first time.
Mm.
So, man.
You know, another thing I would do is if I lost, like, Leah, say Leah was dead, I may go to her gravesite and often masturbate into the ground so the semen would drip down into the casket for her.
Turning him on so much that he's overloaded. Loading.
Hey, we got Fort Wayne's on the call. Hello, Fort Wayne.
Say,
there he is.
Leah is dead.
You gotta turn your shit in the background down.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah.
There it is.
What's going on, man? You want to bang Casey?
No.
Oh.
No, I'll be banging you. No one bangs my ass.
Yeah,
no, that's not what I heard.
It sounds like he's got to be the dominant one, so you would have to be the submissive one, according to what I'm hearing out of Casey is Raw here. Would you be open to that?
No.
So what's up with you, man? What's going on tonight? What's up?
Not much. How about you?
Nothing. What do you what the hell are you here for?
I don't know. Just wanted to talk to you guys.
Oh my God.
I want to talk to you too. But would you take Casey's girlfriend and make her a woman?
Could you explain?
All right.
That's enough of him. I'm going to kill myself. What the fuck?
Said anything but that.
What the fuck was that?
Said anything but that.
Oh my God, man. What the fuck is wrong with the people that call sometimes? I don't know. What do you want to talk about? What the fuck?
Could have said he wanted to lick Casey's ass. Diddle his cock. Yeah, I mean, anything. He could have said anything.
For Christ's sake, bro. Let's find somebody else. Yeah. Let me call into your show. I'm a dumb fuck, yeah. I got chromosome coming out my rear.
Someone should kill me. I'm so stupid, someone should kill me. I'm so stupid, someone should kill me.
Fucking really dumb.
Gets paralyzed.
really do hope this fucking guy fucking falls down a flight of fucking stairs.
Hey, I'm about half joking, half serious about this. But whenever the country starts to open up again, there needs to be a 1 or 2 week warning period beforehand so that everyone can get off the drugs they have become addicted to while in quarantine.
Huh, that's a great point. Beforehand, so that they can get off the drugs. I mean, are they really on that many drugs? I mean, dude, listen. Quarantine rehab, thank you for the 350. I'm like, not concerned at all about people on drugs. Like, I'm sorry. I mean, I know some people worried about it. Just release the hounds, man. That's what I say. Release the hounds and let them suck ass and eat shit and do whatever they want to do as they come spraying out of their fucking canister homes or whatever they're in. 18 people shot the other day. Hey, did we ever get the total on that shit up in Canada?
18. I don't know if it's updated 18. In the last 36 hours or so, but that's
I was convinced. Check. I was convinced that Alien went crazy. You know what I mean?
It's the wrong part of the country.
You know, Leah's got a family member from, she does the ancestry thing, in, or ancestry. And she's got a family member from Nova Scotia. And then she's got another family from Canada because that's the guy who is the Bruins president. Don Sweeney is related to Leah. Is like second cousin to Leah. My wife. Oh. Crazy.
I was talking to someone the other day on Twitter, and I don't know if he actually wanted his name mentioned, but I know who it was that I talked to. He said that he lives right there where that happened, and he actually knew a couple of the people.
Whoa.
Not dentist, but the person that works on like your partials and false teeth, denturist, was one of the victims, I guess.
Right.
Or no, he was the guy shooting. I don't know. I'm having a hard time understanding the tweet now. I'm looking back at it. It was either he was the shooter or it was one of the, he was either way. He was one of the people that died no matter what.
Right.
The first few he killed were personal ex and boyfriend's ex boss.
Oh my God. It was so a fucking on. Like domestic thing over a fucking sex or something or a wife. Or what the fuck?
His ex wife, her boyfriend and an ex boss. And then he just, you know, went the rest of the way. If you got a dick, I'll follow you.
No, was
following a lot
Scotia.
Of dick that day.
Yeah. Friends and, got a family member in Nova Scotia. Luckily
figured out. I figured out who that was that called in a minute ago.
Who's that?
You know the guy on the rant line that does the really awkward Mick Foley deals, impersonations?
Oh,
with
it's him?
Yeah, that was him. And he's like in the middle of a major Twitter war with D. Welsh right now.
Really?
I've been watching him in the chat tonight. And they're just like, fuck you, you're gay.
Well, D. Welsh has donated a whole lot more, so I have to take D. Welsh's side. Although I like that kid, though, that guy that does the I like that guy. I'm sorry, Fort Wayne, but you just, that was terrible. Like, I had to let you go. You know, I mean, it was so bad. I mean, like, but I like
shit
it.
Bum.
I sent you the video, Joe, about the Tish Thotty beggar. She's a dumb fucking bitch. You have to listen.
Justin Gregory, thanks, man. There's been so many Thought Twitch beggars that it's insane. But I'm going to pee my pants, let Drew take over for a minute. And when I get back, I'm going to look her up so I have it so we can talk about her. And then we can talk about Tommy trying to exploit the Leafy situation more and more and more. And then people who exploit Tommy for it. Yeah, I'm sure he's going to go off the rails with that. I'll be right back. Continue, Drew. I'm going to find this thought e-begging cunt. We'll figure it out.
Well, it wouldn't surprise me if Tommy did, just keep going on and on and on with the Leafy thing. I mean, anything for, you know. But what's that, Casey?
Scott brought up something I forgot. Coming up is the 25th anniversary of the Oklahoma City bombing.
Isn't that 25th wild? Anniversary? That doesn't sound right, is it?
25th. It happened in 1995.
That's right. See, I was thinking when I heard 25 years, I was thinking like 2000 for some reason. I knew it was before 98.
Yeah.
April 19th. So it just happened, actually. It just happened April 19th. So a couple days ago.
Oh, okay.
That's interesting. Yeah. Timothy McVeigh, he swapped his vehicles. It was a van, wasn't it, that he drove?
Yeah.
How he transported everything. His vehicle was actually found in Junction City, Kansas, which I usually drive past it a couple times a month. I've been in that city a couple times, and it's like a hotel parking lot is where they found his car, which isn't, you know, it's only a couple hours from here. So I remember when I was looking into it a couple of years ago, I was like, wow, shit, there's a part of the story that has to do with up here even. But yeah, that's fucking insane. And there was why were you bringing it up? What did you have to say about it?
Well, because I was in school during that time.
Well, that's right, because you're not too far from there. Shit, I forgot about that.
And we went to visit on a field trip up there. This is after the bomb hit it, but before they tore it down, you know, the iconic, you know, how the building
the picture of the building being blown out, is that what you're talking about?
Yeah, I saw that, and then it was crazy. Then you don't get to see, you never see about the other buildings behind you that's been blown out from all their windows that's been boarded up. So
it is kind of weird. I mean, if you think of that building, now maybe you might be different because I'm sure you've been past that building prior to, but average American thinks about that building and you think of it being blown out, not what it looked like before.
Well, that was on the other side of the state. It was a 2-3 hours ride up.
But that doesn't mean that you weren't familiar with the building. I don't know, how iconic was it to the skyline? Was it a significant part of the skyline, or was it just another building in the crowd?
It was just pretty much.
Okay. Well, I mean, I guess it's probably more stand out now for obvious reasons. I just thought the building was a little more. I don't know. I guess you just don't think of Oklahoma City as having much of a skyline. So you think of the Murrah Federal Building and you're like, oh, you know, that probably stood out a little bit in a town like Oklahoma City.
It was just wild. I would love to go up there and see the memorial site.
Just farted. I think I might have given myself the corona just now.
You know, when I watched that video this morning, I was like, you know what? That actually makes sense. You know, I mean,
you think about it. Yeah, you think about it. I mean, it's a bodily fluid, for lack of better terms, or, you know, it's a solid, but you know what I mean? It's something that comes out of the body that obviously isn't desirable.
No.
to me, it just made sense, but the headline of it is what cracks me up. And I'm sure that was what cracked Joe up too, and made him bring it up as well. But you know, Timothy McVeigh, I mean, that guy had to really enjoy the cock. I mean, have you looked at him and thought that he was actually, you know, that guy couldn't be straight?
Yeah, he kind
of. Oh, my God. Timothy had to enjoy the cock. Holy shit, dude. That part was fire.
Boy, from one cock lover to another, look who you brought in. No, I'm kidding.
Yeah, Tommy just called up. What's up, Tommy? You want to see my dick, Tommy? Tommy, you want to see my dick? I think he's muted. I'm jumping on Skype, too, if anybody wants. Tommy, if you want to go on video, bro, you can go on Skype, too, if you'd like. But, right now, Tommy, you're...
I see him on mute or anything. I don't know what happened.
I don't hear him. Do you hear him?
Oh, I'm here.
Oh, there you go.
I hear him now.
If you want to jump on Skype, go ahead. But I'm
calling you right now on Skype.
Okay, yeah, we're just going to stay on Twitter, Discord for sound again, because it's such a pain in the ass.
Okay, well, I'm going to take a quick piss myself, and then I'll jump on Skype. I'll be back.
All right, I'll go for it, Drew, yeah? All right, let me add Drew back to the Skype in a minute. I'll add you all back to the Skype in 1 second. But I do have Tommy on Skype. Interesting. There's Rob, the turncoat Gronkowski, baby. There's the turncoat himself right there, Rob Gronkowski. And then there's Tommy, man. He's been on a incredible tour last week, man. He's been on fucking Corrupted, Monetize This.
You need to mute yourself in Skype, Joe.
Oh, yeah, my bad, man. I got to mute you, too. Shit, the doubles.
I've already muted myself.
Oh, God. Yeah, but I got to mute Skype. I didn't do that yet. I'll get it in a second here.
I muted myself.
Oh, good shit. Good shit. All right, cool. But yeah, man, what's up? What's up, Tommy? So you want to... Oh, yeah, you don't care about football, so fuck that, but...
Are you mad at me, Joe?
No. Are you mad at me?
Just a few seconds ago, you were, like, so pissed off at me, and you were, like, saying, don't make Joe do this. Don't make Joe do this. Like, are you mad at me because I retweeted that tweet that...
No, no. What are you talking about? What tweet?
Just 2 seconds ago, I was watching your stream, and you were blazing. You were pissed off.
Yeah.
Like, and you were, like, shooting, like, fire. I could literally hear fire.
Yeah, I saw one of your troll people in the chat, and they were saying something about... maybe Joe will use Tommy again or something like that for what happened with Leafy. Somebody was saying something about Leafy in the chat, and then they were saying maybe Joe will use Tommy again for Leafy. So then yeah, I went on a rant and said, hey, listen, man, if I wanted to fucking, if you want to go down that fucking road, I'll fucking set everybody on fire, motherfucker. But I wasn't really mad at you. I was just responding to him.
Okay.
And then I said, I don't know. I don't really know what's going on. The guy was saying something about... Because there's like a joke, I guess Leafy tweeted a joke out or something about you or something like that.
Yeah, I don't know if it's a joke or if it's to be taken serious with. I don't know what's going on.
No, it's here. A joke. He said, my last video is going to be a 3-hour one on Tommy NC. That's like clearly a joke. Cause like that.
So he's just joking. That's all he's doing.
Yeah, that's a clear joke.
It's cowardly that he doesn't even tag me in it. I think it's interesting that he doesn't even tag me in it.
Yeah, I mean, he's like that.
That's a good point.
But he definitely is, because the video he made on you back in the day was kind of like one of the last things, like one of the things that kind of fucked his whole thing up. So yeah. He's like, my last video is going to be a 3-hour video on Tommy, haha. So that's like a joke. Like, it'd be like if I made a huge mistake in my life and then I was like, hey, I'm going to do that again, like... It's a joke. Why? Who thinks it's real? You think it's real? You thought it was a real thing?
In the back of my head, I'm like, I thought it was real. I thought, like, something was going on here.
Yeah. I had a couple, like, scumbag comments, and I just said, you know. I did say, probably Tommy will use this probably to try to get some kind of clout, and other people will try to use Tommy to get clout off of Tommy. Here it comes again, you know. That's what happened the last time, kind of. That's what everybody said I was doing, even though I was actually helping you. I'm the actual one that actually did help you, but got shit on. Not by you, but, you know. Now I'm the shithead. But, I was just fucking around with that guy who used to talk some shit in the chat. He's deleted now, so. Mm. What else is up, man? What's up? He's gone. He's dead.
Me, not much. I'm just hanging out, just chilling.
Yeah, man.
You got a WWE Hall of Fame ring on your hand?
What?
I thought maybe it's one of those WWE Hall.
No, it's a Batman ring, and I, you know.
I thought it was one of those Hall of Fame rings.
Is that you, Bullfrog?
No, it's Casey.
Oh, okay. You guys sound the same.
Tommy, Are you mad? Are you mad at me again for something?
No, I wasn't mad. I was trying to figure out if you were mad at me. Like, that's what I was trying to figure out here. Like, I listened to the broadcast, and I hear, like, you spouting off and stuff like this. I'm like, wait a minute, is Joe mad at me? Like, that's why I came in here like a man to talk to you and ask you if everything was okay.
I mean, I kind of did. I mean, because the guy was kind of like, he was like one of the guys that white knights for you. So it was one of those guys that white knights for you, that like, you're the greatest thing ever and I'm a scumbag or whatever. So I did kind of go at him about that situation. So I could see how you would think that, actually, because I did say, like...
I didn't see what was going on in the chat. I just heard what you were saying. So I just saw what... I heard what you were saying. I didn't see anything going on in the chat. Like, I...
Yeah, I was just fucking around with this guy a little bit.
I can't read, Joe. I can't read what's going on in the chat.
Well, sometimes you seem to not read, but sometimes you read just fine.
Well, I mean, I can read small sentences, but I can't, like, read... All long sentences.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, Joe was getting a little trolled in the chat.
I was kind of just trolling this guy back who was trolling me. I said I've got everything documented and all the voice messages and all the videos and everything that's ever happened. So if he wanted to accuse me of any more bullshit, I could expose everybody and blow this whole fucking community into the world and the atmosphere. And I just was fucking with him.
Mm.
But yeah, I could see how it would make you nervous. It should make a lot of people nervous.
I'm not nervous. I was just seeing what was going on and see if you were mad at me. Or...
No, I'm just fucking around, though. But yeah, Tommy, what's up, man? What do you call about? What's how's it hanging?
Not much, man. Just chilling. Just hanging out. Having a good time. Living life to the fullest. And just quarantining it up.
How you doing?
I'm doing okay. You know, just...
I thought it was hilarious. I just got back. I thought it was hilarious when you're like, is that you, Bullfrog? The look on your face. You looked like you had seen a ghost when you made that connection.
He is in the chat.
That's it? Nothing?
What?
Nothing, Tommy?
I have nothing for him. I have, you know, I don't really much care about him.
I mean, he didn't really deliver much on Friday night.
He's a kike.
Oh. We get to that conclusion.
His gay friend told me.
Oh.
You think he actually got, ever got laid?
I'll tell you what, though. If you do want to see your, like, fucking videos come down and your life be fucked up, you get in a brawl with Leafy, bro. You get in a brawl with Leafy, and I'll tell you, man, his fans, if you're worried about the JCS community, the Leafy community will fucking, they'll give away your fucking mother's work address in about 2 seconds. So yeah, if you dabble into that fucking atmosphere, I'll tell you, man, they will come get you. But so, Tommy, what'd you think about all that shit? So you really thought, so you were mad about Leafy's tweet? Is that what you're saying?
I was curious about his tweet, and I was curious about it. That's what I was. I wasn't mad about his tweet. I was curious, more of like curious. Somebody brought it to my plate. Somebody brought it to my attention, the tweet today. And that just raised my eyebrow.
One of your 100 spies that spies on everything for you?
No, they're not a spy. They just somebody that was wanting to let me know that Leafy said something about me.
Oh. Yeah. Oh, it seems like anytime anybody says anything, you have more birdies than anyone, Tommy.
Well, Joe, you have a lot of birdies too. Like you have a lot of people that fly around you too. And like we all, I would say, we have birdies, I would say, you know, because 100 times, like 2 or 3 times a day, you know, I'll be on Instagram and I'll see at Joe Cronin. Look at this. Look what Tommy's doing. And like, that's kind of a birdie there.
I don't even respond to those. I don't see those. You know, I don't even see those tags. I mean, half the time you tell me that you did a video on Instagram, I don't even know about it.
He's referring more to the DMs and stuff.
Yeah, I'm talking about more other things. But yeah, you got a lot of birds.
You know what I thought was funny about his tweet? That the first person to jump in there
Ricky
on
Berwick.
Top of that was Ricky Berwick. And I despise Ricky Berwick. I kind of he
because he's like a better retard.
No, it's not that. The fact that he snubbed me. Like the fact that before he was even famous, I asked for an interview, and he snubbed me. And, you know, I was like, I wasn't going to, like, criticize him. I don't know. Like, I was just going to interview the guy. Like, any person that knows when you come on my talk show, I don't criticize you. Like, I interview you. I ask you questions. We have a good conversation. Joe has been on my show. So many people from this community have been on my show, and they see what the show is like. Like, I interview you.
But don't
I
you
have
think,
a conversation.
But Ricky Berwick probably just doesn't know. And, I mean, why don't you just stay positive? I thought the whole thing is stay positive. Why
I
would
am.
You...
I do stay positive.
But no,
but
you
kinda,
you
want to
see Ricky Berwick.
Ricky Berwick snubbed me.
You don't know, Tommy. He could have been busy, man. He, you know, probably looking for a new pair of legs or something like that.
Yeah, he's probably looking for a new kid to bang. No, but so listen, I don't think a lot of people I don't think he's ever done really many interviews. I don't think Ricky Berwick does interviews. I've almost never seen it.
I didn't know that. Like, I didn't know that. I if the guy hadn't done any interviews, it'd be cool to have him. For instance, you know, I did an interview with the Americans. They've never done an interview at all. And he was so kind to come on my show and do an interview. Like, that's a person I have respect for. Like, the guy, the creator of the Americans, he came on my show, did an interview, and we had a great time. Like,
well, Tommy, let me ask you this. Should I be mad at you for the snub? Should I be mad at you for when the whole Leafy thing went down? And
Joe, technically, you blocked me on Facebook.
Yeah, but let me ask you this.
Joe wanted to go his separate way, so I just went my separate way, and I didn't think you're skipping.
So you come, I come to you, and I tell you, Leafy made this video. And you get angry and you want me to make a video. And then I tell you to make a video right now. And you go and you make that video. And I titled it for you. I even titled the video for you. And the video got 2 million views, right? And you went viral because of that. Now, and then you went to go live in front of like 10,000 people and you couldn't do it. So I went live for you on your channel from my house. And then because of that, I was inundated with hate from thousands of people, from Keemstar to Leafy, thousands of people saying that I was just using you for your clout, right, Tommy? You remember that?
A little bit, yeah. I think I remember that.
So anyway, then I said to you, Tommy, I said, Tommy, these people are coming at me hard, bro. This is crazy. Like, I'm like under full-scale attack, like doxing, people trying to say they're going to kill me. All these other things, Keemstar's people, all these things. And this all started because you wanted me to make a rant video on Leafy, but instead I told you to make a video in the state that you were in, and you did it. And I asked you then, I said, Tommy, can you make a video about me saying that, you know, listen, guys, Joe Cronin is my friend. He went live from my channel for me because my internet was down. He's not leeching off me and all these things. Can you just tell people, like, I'm not this weird scumbag? Like, because I'm doing all this stuff to help you, and I'm getting buried by thousands of people. And you get 100,000 subs, and all I got was fucking hated on. You can still look up the Reddit post to this day. And then, Tommy, you made that video for me. And then within 14 hours, you took the video down. You remember that?
Yeah. Which to this day I still feel bad about that.
I'm not trying to make you feel bad all over again. I'm just saying. Maybe that's why I blocked you on Facebook then, because then I was like, wow. And you know what's crazy, Tommy, is that, listen, I love you, but my wife is not like me. She's more like, let people figure it out on their own. Don't help anybody. She was yelling at me when I was describing to you, like, get off the phone with me now. Make a video, Tommy. I'll title it for you. I hung up the phone, and my wife said, why would you even help him? He's still just end up shitting on you or something. And I'm like, no, I think we can get this video to go viral, and I think this is going to be crazy good. You know, and I thought it would get 20,000 views, and it got 2 million almost. And then you were on the top trending thing on Reddit on that video. And if me and you never talked that night, that video wouldn't have happened. It's crazy to me. Now, I'm not looking for a dick sucking, like, every second. I'm just sick of the people who say that, like, I'm some kind of weird person using you, when back then all I was trying to do was help you get this shit to work so you'd fucking kill it. So, like, when I see people say that, it's kind of like, this is kind of fucked up, because I've always done the opposite with Tommy. And I had your...
You know, like, I was turning my back on, I'm sorry, Joe, and it was like, I had somebody else in my ear saying some shit to me, and I apologize if I ever turn my back on you.
And you had someone else in your ear always against me, it seems like.
Well, if the person you want to be mad at, that was James Worley at that time. Like, he, you know, like, he was the one that went in my ear.
And James Worley's also the one that told you to interview the Nazi lady. And James Worley's the one that also told you to delete a video that you could have appealed instead of having a strike for 3 months. And instead,
and that's
you
why I don't
it.
Talk with the guy anymore. I don't work with the guy anymore. Like you know, he betrayed me. Like, you know, like I gave that guy so many chances and he betrayed me.
Right. But it's but yeah, I just want to say that, like, I bring that up to say that there are so many weird sickos that follow you and use you and you don't even know it. Like, you think so many people are your friend. And unfortunately, because I'm not Whirly, because Whirly was really harsh with you about stuff, but then he also just did lied to you about things. But what's weird is, it just keeps happening with you, man. It's weird. I don't know why people take advantage of you like they do, but it seems like they constantly just. I can see why people were mad at me during that thing, because everybody else seems to take advantage of you. So this guy must be doing that too. You know what I mean? Like, I mean, dude, no good deed goes unpunished. I will tell you that. Every time I do something like, I'm going to help somebody, or I'm going to do this, I got a good idea to help something, it always backfires in my fucking face. Like, at the time, I was in a war with Tommy C, and that guy ended up getting huge all because of this situation. So not only did I help out with that, but then he got big because of that too. It's like I literally, it was hilarious. And I've done this several other times before where I've done little things and then something blows up and it's like, wow, why did I even bother helping somebody? So that's why I think that I don't help people almost at all anymore. Or I don't even tell people how to title their videos better or how to do anything. Because I just go, it'll just end up being, they'll just shit on you in the end. You know, they'll do something like what Coop Comedian did, you know. They'll just turn around and be like, you know what? You're a racist guy who should be dead and just flipping out. You know, so it's like, what the fuck is the point anymore in helping anybody with anything? But so, yeah, I think, Tommy, I believe that, like, I think that tweet is obviously a joke. I can't believe that the guy's not really going to make a video on you. I wouldn't think. He's just making an ironic joke, like, haha, I'll do 3 hours on him. But yeah, who do you hate more, Ricky Berwick or Leafy?
I don't, like, here's the thing. I don't hate either of the people. Like, I don't hate either any one of them, really. Like, it technically was Leafy's viewers that gave me the shit. So I got mad at Leafy's viewers. But some of them reversed and came over to my channel, like, you know, so I can't hate all of his people. So, you know, it's like, you know, it's a whirlwind of, like, who is who and who is what. But there was still people that made death threats. There was still people that were, like, overwhelming my channel with crap.
But you can't really hold him accountable for what, you know, some of the trolls are there. I mean, the trolls are there.
No, I can't. Like, you know, but he was the one that pulled the trigger and that released all those bullets out. You know, like, they.
Yeah.
And, like, interesting fact, when I went on Tosh, Daniel tried to talk about Leafy, and I gave my opinion on it, and they didn't even put in the episode, like, you know, because I did the whole meme hashtag no chin. I was making a joke and they cut that out there completely.
Well, I wonder if I don't know, I just feel like it's such an old thing, like it's from so many years ago now. This guy's like an older person now. He's not even like a young kid like he was, you know. Now he smokes weed out of Billy the Fridge's grundle. Are you aware of this?
I heard that him and Billy were actually really close for a long time. That's what I heard.
Why did you just move your camera so far to the right?
I was just moving it over to the green screen. Like, I was trying to get it near my put it on my green screen.
Okay. I thought you moved yourself off camera. I was like, what the hell am I looking at now? There's Tommy. Look at him all sexy. But yeah, so anyway, yeah, I think it's a lot about nothing, you know what I mean? A lot to do about nothing. And I think the guy just made a little joke on Twitter. I mean, did James Whirly bring this to your attention?
No, somebody else did.
Well, somebody else is probably stirring the pot for you. Probably the same as Whirly did with me.
Well, he wasn't trying to stir the pot. He was just telling me that Leafy made a tweet about me, and I was like, I wasn't even paying attention to Twitter or anything about Leafy. I was playing GTA 5, hanging out, just chilling.
There's a birdie right there. There's a person you got to be careful of, man. That's a birdie. You're playing your games. You're ignoring everything. Someone's bringing up drama about this or that. Hey, man. there's your birdie right there. Probably the center of all your troubles. Probably Hamza or Whirly. But let me tell you something about Hamza and Whirly. They made love one time on a beach near San Francisco, and they both came at the same time, okay? Let me tell you that. Oh, here comes the sexy transylver. About to come down the aisle. Here comes Tommy, NC2010. Here he is. Here comes Tommy.
Sexy transvestite from sexual Transylvania.
Corona Chan is the nickname some people gave the virus.
Oh.
Patreon and Kickstarter are getting wrecked from this crash like the comic book industry and Disney. To be honest, Patreon and Kickstarter deserve it for catering to SJWS and Antifa.
Yeah, that's true, Bimbo Baggins. Patreon kicked off a lot of good creators and supported the terrorists. Like Antifa. Here's Rob Gronkowski. Oh, God. Oh, I forgot my video wasn't on. There it goes. Look at that. Look at that.
But that's... whatever you need, ever you got, ever you want, I'll take back again. Whatever you need, ever you got, ever you want.
Tommy, how much does that look like Mongoloid JB to you? Doesn't that look just like Mongoloid JB?
I mean, it looks like JB.
Yeah, exactly like him.
Thicker neck version of JB.
Right, right. And hey, you know, if we beat up Ashley's vagina, it would look like his wife.
Fuck you, Joe.
I'm sorry. I'm kidding. I'm joking.
Give me a hell yeah!
Oh.
Joe, apparently Tommy thought quarantine meant quarantine, so he's been making eat the quarters that he shoved in his ass after he pooped it out. Help
Dumbass.
Me, Joe. I would rather be wrapped by 10 black guys like Drew than suffer this.
That's fucking horrible. That is horrible. This is suffering. Future Joe. Oh my God, Future Joe. Thank you for coming back and warning me about the future. There's so many things I need help with.
That's what I call see-through bra right there.
Oh, look at that.
I'm like, what are you doing?
What else we got?
Oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it. That's
want
it.
Some bubbly? Look at this stuff. Oh, a little bit of the
no.
bubbly.
That's it.
Speaking of backstabbers, is Drew's wife ready for round two of Operation Ground and Pound? He'll take those sloppy seconds like ordering a lurkworm $5 Little Caesars pizza.
Oh, Little Caesars pizza, Goon. Thank you. Well, this video...
Change your name there, Goon.
This video is getting age-restricted. And if it does...
You're
we're
lucky.
All, if it does, we're all attacking Tommy's channel tomorrow, so... Well, better hope that doesn't get hit, Tommy, or I am going to blame you for that.
Jesus.
You are.
Well, I barely had on the screen.
It doesn't matter, you idiot.
$50. I'm gonna take my dick out because you donated $50.
God damn,
you
Tommy,
donated $50, motherfucker boy. I'm a rich motherfucker.
Drew that whiny kid on Twitter at MadAllen2002. He's been blocked by many from the JCS army. He whines when people call him out on his immature videos and when people block him.
Another
in
guy.
The one donating to Joe, he hasn't donated once.
It's that Fort Wayne guy.
Oh, that's him. Funny. Yeah, D.
That's
Welsh.
That's funny because I think he sent that in before I mentioned anything.
Yeah, D. Welsh is in a full fight with this guy.
The guy made a video pretending to be D. Welsh, I guess, and Welsh got pissed too.
I'm trying to get your channel straight.
Well, why would you do that? You can't show that stuff on YouTube. Okay, would you show that on your channel?
No.
Then why would you show it on mine?
I'm sorry. Like, I didn't think that you could see anything.
What do you mean? You're on the Skype video.
My bad, Joe. I'm sorry.
Tommy,
I thought it was just funny. I didn't think that would be...
You know, it would be funny if I put up a girl's vagina on your channel. Can I do that?
No.
That'd be funny. God damn, Tommy. It's like you hate me. It's literally like...
I don't hate you, Joe.
How many times is Joe going to try to help me with something or do something? I'm going to fucking ruin his ass, though. Like, what the fuck? I've already been striked once because of you, because I made a video talking about you. That came down. Can you imagine if your video came down because of my community, because you went on a rant about my community? You would go off for, like, months about that. Your community took down my video, and I couldn't go live for 3 months. That was your community.
Well, I didn't tell him to do that.
I know, but neither Ricky Berwick didn't tell his community to do anything either. You know what I mean? But I'm saying if it happened to you, you would be ranting on me for you'd be pissed at whoever did it. You'd be furious. You'd lose your mind, Tommy. God damn, man. Just like when you spoil all the fucking movies for everybody, but then you're like, oh, but don't tell me about the end of the Joker or whatever the hell it was, the Marvel. I don't know what it was. But God damn it, man.
Sorry.
God, I hate myself. Tommy, you've made me hate myself more than I hated myself yesterday. D. Welsh, thank you for the $50 bomb, D. Welsh. Thank God, D. Welsh. Thank you. Holy shit. It probably will get age restricted, though. I will say that.
Are you going to hate yourself even worse tomorrow?
Yes, I hate myself, dude. I wish I could go back in time to 2015 to when Tommy called in for the Raw Review, and I hang up on him. Oh, I just fucking hang up on him. Tommy would have ended his YouTube career when he couldn't get past 3,000 subs.
I would have never ended my YouTube career.
Tommy C would have overdosed on fucking kid penis. You know, like, and nobody would have fucking, and you know what I mean? You know, they never would have started that fucking baited thing. So Keemstar would have ended up getting caught in a drug raid and gone to jail, and his channel would have been gone. Oh, God. Anything for views never would have gotten his bump. He would have ended up showing his dick on YouTube and getting taken down and disappearing and then eventually going to jail for stealing crack cocaine. You know, I mean, the lives of so many people would be altered. Think about all the lives that would be altered if Tommy just hadn't called that Raw Review in 2015.
Is this like the Back to the Future kind of...
Yes.
Where you go back from...
The fly effect.
Yeah, this is the butterfly effect. That's exactly what this is. The butterfly fucking effect. It's in full fucking force right now. New subscriber. We got a sub somehow. Somebody's subbing to this shit. Glizok, thank you for the sub, man. What's going on?
If you want me to, Joe, I'll leave. You know.
I want you to leave. I'm kidding, Tom. It's okay. I'm just joking. It was kind of funny, actually.
It's until you show a dick here in about 5 minutes.
Yeah, I mean, she's wearing clothes. It's okay. Not really, but you know, whatever. You know, I had a friend in high school. If I went over his house, he would flip the fuck out if you did anything like I remember I got some cookie crumbs, just a few crumbs on the couch. And he flipped out on me. Like, he got angry. He goes, what are you doing, man? Like, come on. And he got, like, really angry. And I was like, oh, my bad, dude. And then I started thinking. And I thought back to only about a month earlier. We were all over my house. And in my living room, he actually jumped. We were all going crazy in the living room. He jumped up on my couch and was running around on my couch. And his shoes were dirty. And he got dirt all over the fucking couch. And I was like, what the fuck, bro? And I was like, the couch is fucked, you know? And he was laughing about it. And then I was laughing. And here we are, like, a couple months later, and I'm over his house. And he's done a bunch of destruction in my house. And I'm over his house, and I spilt literally, like, two little crumbs came off of this cookie. And he was, like, wicked anal and crazy about it. And then I just remembered what he was doing over my house all these years. And I don't know why, but I got fucking enraged, and I started fucking with him the rest of the night, like, oh, better not fucking get this over here. I can't stand that shit. Don't do this over here, but I'll do a million things over your shit. That fucking, I don't know why, but that enrages me, because
all the hypocrite,
right? And it's like so enraging to me. I don't know why. Like, it's no big deal. Like, if I spill crumbs, because I was like, oh, fuck, sorry, man, I spilled some crumbs. And then he's like, dude, come on, man. Like, eat it upstairs then. You know, and he got mad. And I'm like, are you fucking serious? So, like, that type of thing, dude. God, I wish I choked that guy back in the day. I wish I said, you know what, motherfucker? And I choked him. And then I put him down on his own carpet. And then I peed on his head and in his ear.
Must have been like fucking God himself or something, because who doesn't have crumbs when they take a bite out of a cookie or a cracker or whatever the fuck, a potato chip?
Dude, I'm telling you.
Are you the one person on earth that doesn't produce crumbs?
You can produce crumbs from almost anything.
When I saw that
Dave
Chappelle skit, That Dave Chappelle skit came out, I think, 3 years after that. And when I saw that skit, I was dying because I was like, oh my God, that's my buddy.
Fuck your couch, nigga. Buy another one, you rich motherfucker. Fuck your couch, nigga. Fuck your couch. Fuck your couch, nigga. Fuck your couch.
I missed that show.
Yeah, we really, oh God, we should have had 7 to 10 years of the Chappelle show. I'm pissed off.
Then he went cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs and then went to Africa.
Oh. Yeah. Wait a minute. You calling him a Cocoa Puff because he's black?
No, he went crazy. He went crazy and went to Africa.
Oh, apparently. Okay. Yeah. Yeah. That's kind of what happened a little bit. Yeah. He kind of went. Yeah. He kind of just.
And apparently, he read a book about a pimp or something like that. And that really pissed him off how the pimp would treat the women or something like that. And then. He just, after he read that, he just said, he just left. He just, like, just went, that's what made him go crazy, apparently.
See, I thought it was a bit on the show that made him really upset, like a minor bit that said.
I think it was like a lot of things adding up, including even some of the humor where, I remember him mentioning that, like, you know, there was like a lot of white people.
He was the writer of that show. He wrote everything, didn't he?
Well, no, he didn't write.
No.
There was
someone else helping them out.
It was a white guy writing.
Yeah,
and I wouldn't doubt it. Paul Mooney helped as well. He was on that show, and he had a couple other guys on that show.
So I thought you were saying that he looked like the Cocoa Puffs bird, Tommy.
No, I wasn't saying that. I was saying that he went cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs.
Okay, chocolate milk. It says on the Cocoa Puffs. But no, there was a white guy that wrote it, and I think, you know, he wrote a lot of stuff, too. He did. He wrote a bunch of the shit. But there was a guy who did it, and I feel like I remember him saying at one point that he was, like, uncomfortable with the fact that, like, you know, all these white people were, like, coming up to him in the streets and saying all these, like, sort of...
Well, he'd be at Disney, and he'd be with his kids, and people were like, I'm Rick James, biatch! And they're like, he's like, excuse me, I'm with my kids. You know, I'm like, but that's what happens, dude, when you do comedy like that. You know, people are going to come up to you and not know that you're with your kids.
I was talking more along the lines of, like, white people coming up to him or white people sort of saying these sort of, like, slang terms that the black community knew, but a lot of white people didn't know. And now kind of Dave Chappelle was responsible for bringing these sort of slang terms and inside terms, if you want to say it like that, to, like, the mainstream of white people. Like, so, you know, African American community has all these little slang terms for different things, and suddenly he's using them on his show, and his show is massively popular with everybody, and now you got white people walking around like, hubba-donk-a-donk, ha ha. And then, so, like, black people must have just been like, what the fuck? Like, now we gotta come up with a different word. You know, like, so, like, sort of that type of thing. I that was part of it, but then there was other things with the show creators and him that they didn't see things. And then, yeah, you know what? He just went fucking, he got crazy. He didn't know how to, like, holy shit, I'm famous. Like,
I think it was also about the money he was about to receive. Didn't he, for like, was it 5 or years that he's supposed to get, like, all combined, like, $50 million?
It was, I think it was, $50 million. It was more, wasn't it? What, oh, God, was it $50 million? I thought,
$50 million was what I remember, too.
I thought it was $200 million.
He got something right.
I thought it was $5 million, but maybe it was 5 years and $50 million.
It is windy outside.
Was it 2 years or 5 years?
Yeah, it was windy today. Yeah, it was $55 million. $55 million, you're right.
What did you say about Wendy's?
Windy.
No, it's Wendy, dumbass.
Oh, Wendy. Oh, I'm sorry.
Serving it up, baby.
It's been oddly windy this today.
Yeah. Yeah, it was windy. I mean, it was windy the other day for us, too. And it was super windy, obviously, last week when we had the storm. I mean, dude, you should see the shit down in my backyard. There's massive branches, like branches that I can barely pick up. In my backyard, there's like 6 of them. But, you know, the tree's going to come down soon anyway, so fuck it, you know?
Oh, you mean the tree that looks like the devil's pitchfork and it looks like it's going to come down on your house?
Yes, that tree is coming down soon. Dude, it was... I'm telling you, man, it was scary the other day. Like, when I was watching the neighbor's houses, I mean, like, I was... Dude, I mean, fucking, it was crazy.
Joe, this is the voice of the tree in your backyard. Hello, Joe Cronin. I'm in your backyard. Ooh, I might fall on your house. Maybe I won't. Maybe I will. Maybe I won't.
Well, I got to tell you, I am a little freaked out about that tree cracking and breaking. But even with the 70-mile-an-hour winds, that tree was not rocking too hard. But I'll tell you, though, the neighbor's trees, they were fucking rolling. Like, these trees were bending like crazy. And when that tree fell on the neighbor's house, I guess the guy is like 80 years old, you know what I mean? And like lives by himself. So, you know, everybody was going over to check on him and he's so okay. But this tree fucking sat on his house for a while. And you can
hey,
see
Joe,
it.
I got a quick question. Hurricane Sandy hit.
Are you jerking off you or get... something? What the
Loading.
Fuck?
Loading.
Loading. Shut the fuck. When Hurricane Sandy hit, did it really affect you guys up there?
No, not really. We got some 40 mile an hour winds or less, and then it just passed on. You know.
When I went to work that the very next day, I worked on a train yard that we had semi trailers everywhere.
Yeah.
And one of them blew over from the hurricane.
Holy
I was like,
shit.
What the fuck?
Well,
we lost power.
I'm telling everybody right now, and I said this 3 weeks ago, and I'll keep saying it every week. Get ready. Be ready this year, man. There is going to be some massive hurricanes this year. I think there's going to be massive hurricanes. I think there's going to be massive earthquakes. Like, in places you wouldn't expect. The tornadoes, I think. I mean, dude. And I was just feeling this way at the beginning. I was feeling this way weeks ago. In fact, I've been feeling this way since the groundhog said early spring. I said, man, it feels like there's going to be something nasty this year. And so I didn't think it was going to be coronavirus. But, you know, but that, now if you look at the meteorologists and the seismologists and all those type of people, a lot of them are saying it. So obviously I don't know what the fuck I'm talking about. I just got a feeling. What the fuck does that mean? But go listen to the experts. Because they're starting to fucking say it. Something's coming this year. And it's going to be nuts.
I wonder if the Earth preparing itself has anything to do with that.
I don't know.
I wonder if that's going to affect it even further.
The Earth is going to shake us off.
Ozone's closing up.
Now, I'm not even talking about, like, Florida, Nessa. Like, I'm not even talking necessarily, like, you know, places that we know it's going to be. I'm talking about some of the places you're not used to seeing it happen.
Oh, shit. They have all kinds of stuff that happens. I mean, fuck, on the West Coast, you got earthquakes. In the Midwest, we got tornadoes. In the East Coast, you got hurricanes. So
yeah.
You're not safe anywheres.
You ain't safe nowhere, sucker.
Yeah, if you're looking to get away from natural disasters, there's not too many places to go. And, I mean, you can quantify that as even, like, snowstorms or, you know, high amounts of rain or, you know, natural disasters is probably too strong of a term.
Yeah.
But if you're looking to get away from fucked up weather altogether, you need to get off this fucking planet. And then you got other things to deal with.
Yeah, I mean, honestly, dude, I know I live here and everything, but... This ain't a bad place to be. New England is a real... If you want to avoid disasters, New England's a pretty good place to go. But, you know, there... But snow. You know, there's...
I would see, nor'easters was what I would say with you guys.
Yeah, we get
there's
those.
Always something.
But it's always so minor compared, you know. But, yeah, obviously, blizzard snow. Like, we get some blizzards and things like that. But I don't know. To me, like, blizzards just aren't as threatening as... tornadoes and earthquakes and, you know, hurricanes.
Unless you have like a flat roof or something, there's really not much in the way of damage that you have to worry about with that. Because, you know, it's temporary. It's a temporary inconvenience because you're stuck at home or whatever. So it's basically like what we're doing now anyways. So, but as far as like damage to your home or damage to your livelihood, it's very minimal. So
Tommy,
I would rather deal with snowstorms over a lot of other shit.
Tommy, I'm sorry, Casey. Real quick, Tommy Leafy, you know, obviously saying he's going to do 3 hours on you. I obviously believe that that's a comical tweet joke. But Tommy, let's pretend it's real and it's really coming. Tommy NC 2010, you're on the Joe Cronin show. front of hundreds of people, thousands probably will see this. Tommy, what do you have to say to Leafy if he plans on attacking you again for 3 hours?
I'm going to say this. I'm going to stand up for myself no matter what. And all I got to say is to you, Leafy, is bring it. I ain't afraid of you.
Yeah.
You're a gutless coward. Back in 2016, I tried to arrange a meeting with you and a Google Plus Hangout, and you shot me down. And Hamza told me the reason why you probably didn't do it is because your lawyers probably told you not to, but you were too afraid, so you held behind. You were stay behind your lawyers and stuff like that. So yeah. I'm not afraid of you, Leafy.
And
I could actually take you in a fight. Yeah, I'm actually probably taller than you. I'm actually 5'10". I probably could take you.
Yeah, and so Tommy, you would win in a physical altercation. Is that what you're saying?
Yeah, I could take Leafy in an altercation probably.
Now he has stated in the past that he would fuck you up on private streams, like not on streams that were public, but on these like little hidden streams. So you think you could F him up?
Yeah, I think I could.
I like it. I like where you're going with this. What if his big fat friend Billy the Fudge Packer jumped in?
Well, Billy the Fridge is my friend. Like Billy would be on my side, honestly. Like Billy,
I don't know. Are you sure? No, listen, he's my friend too. Billy's friends with me too. But listen, I think he would turn on both of us for that anorexic cocaine sniffer. Yes. Yeah, I think he would do anything to sniff the butthole of Leafy's cocaine ass filled fucking grundle. But but Tommy though, let's say it does. It comes down to another battle here with you and him. Would you make another video crying about leaving YouTube, or would you make a video saying that, you know, the cannons are loaded and I'm coming for you?
Yep, I would. The cannons are loaded and I'm coming for you, Leafy.
Hell yeah, Tommy's coming for you, Leafy. You hear that? Unbelievable. So there you go. And what about Keemstar, too? Don't you want to get him? Remember I put Keemstar... Because I put Keemstar in the title of your original video where you were going to give up on YouTube and life. And Keemstar could never figure out why that was in the title. And he was like, why am I in the title? Remember that, Tommy? And
yeah.
Then you took it out of the title because you found out that he had nothing to really do with it.
Yeah.
But he really did have something to do with it because his fans were attacking you. So that was kind of true, to be honest.
Oh, it was a mixture of fans. Like, it was a mixture of fans.
I remember that. And by the way, listen, Leafy's afraid of you. He won't do an interview with you. Keemstar is terrified of me. He's been in my chat, and he wouldn't even call because he was scared, bro. They're scared of us because of what we can do to them physically. Can you imagine if I hopped on a fucking quad and drove my way up to fucking Saskatchewan, New York, or wherever the fuck that gnome fuck lives? And I showed up at his doorstep to face him in a fucking fucking quad race. You know what I mean? Do you know how much? I mean, listen. First of all, Tommy C told me about all the cocaine that Keemstar does. Anyway, so if we got in a race, he'd probably crash into a fucking tree in his backyard up there somewhere in Syracuse or Schenectady or wherever he is. But Tommy, could you beat me in a quad race? That's what I want to know.
What's a quad?
Never mind.
Is that the thing that has like the two wheels on and the kids ride around on?
Yeah.
Yes, that's it, Tommy.
I've seen those. Like, if I could keep my balance, I think I probably could. Like, I don't like things with two wheels. Like, I hate things with two wheels. What? Like, because I just
I'm never good with
keeping my balance.
I hate things with two wheels. That's just such a random fucking, such a random statement.
Well, I can ride a bike. I can ride a bike, but like things that are electric and like only have two wheels, like I don't like them. Me and I, that's why I've never ridden a motorcycle before.
Well, that's not bad.
I like things with four wheels, like a four wheeler. You know, like I could drive one of those.
You mean with a quad amount of wheels, quadruple wheels?
Yeah. Let's. I mean, you know, I can respect where you're coming from with all this. You know. Do you remember when Scarce made that video about me, Tommy? Because I was defending you as always.
Oh yeah, I remember that.
Do you remember this, everybody? Like, I think I played this the other day. I played this a couple days ago. But yeah, I thought it was funny that Scarce actually reported on the video I made.
Leafy didn't know that, so I'm not going to put that on Leafy. It's not like he knew that he had autism or anything like that. But someone actually came out with a video, and this guy's name is Joe Cronin, and he has his own show. He uploaded a video today. He has almost 30,000.
I love this still.
1,000 subscribers, and the title of it is Young Joe Cronin. Friend with Autism and the War Begins. So I don't know what he's playing.
I also spelled U with just a U. Hey, look at that. At the time, I only had 29,000 subs.
Planning on doing in this whole war. I don't know if he's going to keep making videos about Leafy and stuff, but I did kind of see where he was coming from here. He was...
You're damn right you saw where I was coming from, Scarce. By the way, where is Scarce now? Is he still making videos?
He's still making videos, but like the Keemstar War and him are not really going at it anymore.
Right. I think I'm going to get back into the commentary community. I think I'm going to get back at everybody and start going savage again. I think it's time for Joe Cronin to come back out of the woodwork and go after these cocksuckers everywhere.
You want
to
see my dick? I'll take my dick out right now. I'm Sean View Entertainment.
Here he comes.
And you want to see my dick? Do you want to see my dick? I will show you my penis. I'm Sean View. Don't screw with me or else I'll show you my penis.
I mean, this guy took his dick out and never got his YouTube channel taken away.
Tommy, since no woman really loves you, I can be the closest you ever get to some real tits. The only thing is it comes with dick. Let me put something more enjoyable than quarters in your ass as I powerbomb you into the woman's title and pin you with love.
What the fuck?
Wow, what the fuck? Tommy, what the fuck? Native beast? He claims to be a longtime listener of yours. And
I have no idea.
He says he's a gay man.
Joe Bullfrog is going crazy in Discord wanting to talk to Tommy. He wants some lol.
Oh yeah, tell him to go fucking hop on a lily pad and jerk himself off.
What are we gonna crowd in there?
You fucking failed on Friday night against Tommy. I mean, it was horrible. All right, Why Societies? Wow, I don't usually see Why Society in the Discord. Why Society? It's been a while. What's going on?
Your washing machine turned off for this show.
It may be. It may very well be. That was disgusting. That was absolutely disgusting. It's Bolzy. Thank you, Bolzy. Oh, no, that was Broken Lion. Thank you, Broken Lion. Oh, here comes It's Bolzy. Here comes It's Bolzy.
I'm from sexy transvestite from sexual Transylvania. Sexy transvestite from sexual Transylvania.
Fuck his wife.
Bullfrog wants on dudes. He cannot wait to be in with Tommy. Sorry, Tommy, I know you don't like him.
Well, I think Tommy likes him more than Dr. Earl, so...
It's three more donations about Bullfrog, and he...
Listen.
I'm actually fixing ready to jump off. I'm exhausted.
Well, in that case, let's put him on. Fuck it. Might as well put him on for the last second. Let him get his little one comment in.
Tommy, come on.
Tommy.
No, I'm just tired. I'm not leaving because of
Bullfrog.
But
let me get him in real quick. I just want to see what he actually wants to say to you real quick. Then you can get out of here. I know you're tired. Just real quick. Bullfrog, what do you want to say to Tommy? He's here. He's got to go to bed. What do you want to say to Tommy?
I want to fight Tommy. I want to gobble his ass.
Oh,
you want to gobble his...
Bullfrog.
Loading.
You want to gobble his ass?
I want to fight that fucking Black Mountain bitch.
Why do you want to...
Tommy, you fake piece of shit.
Fuck you, Bullfrog.
Fuck you. You fucking Wendy gobbly bitch. I want to fucking wrestle your ass.
you know, the fact is I know what it is
you
about
dick
you, Bullfrog.
You dick-crazy-looking motherfucker.
You're just irrelevant. That's all you are.
Yeah, you're irrelevant. I'll show you irrelevant, bitch. I want to fucking...
Wah.
Yeah, Tommy. Tommy, why don't you wrestle me, you fucking coward, you fucking piece of shit?
Wow. You say wrestle him? You want to wrestle him now?
Yeah, I want to wrestle his ass.
God damn.
What is your finisher?
The frog splash.
Jesus.
Sure, figured.
Yo, ADTR is on the
Tommy,
call.
You fake piece of shit.
He left Bullfrog. He left. He left Bullfrog. ADTR, what's up, man?
Hey, what's up, guys? How are you guys doing?
I'm doing somewhat okay. I'm surprised I'm still in the air, to be honest. But
that coward.
Yeah, he's a coward. He's a coward.
Tommy, I would have gobbled your ass. Come back, you coward.
Well, both of us. Oh,
jeez.
Jesus Christ.
I mean, this
yeah,
is sad.
I'm just testing out my new PC I bought a couple days ago. So I tried Discord. It was a lot of money for me to buy it, but it was worth it.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I do that. Sick. I've, I haven't moved off of,
Fuck.
I want to bite Tommy that fucking piece of shit.
Jesus.
I'm about to break something.
You know what he's talking
about? Tommy,
like
come
that.
Back here, you fucking coward.
Is it me or does he sound like that,
Tommy, I'm going to come find you in Black Mountain, you fucking coward.
Jesus.
That one guy, the Tourette's guy, he sounds like the Tourette's guy.
You better hide, you bitch. I'll come find you.
All right, Bullfrog.
Yeah,
Bullfrog.
Look up Tourette's guy. Right.
Oh, I know who he is.
All right, Bullfrog. Thank you. Thank you for calling, Bullfrog.
Damn.
That's about all I could take of that. Dr. Earl is here on the phone.
What the fuck, dude?
Oh,
what's up, Earl? How you doing,
Break
Earl?
Break this one down, Doc.
I think we got our next pay-per-view.
Yeah, who do you think wins in that situation? You think it's Tommy or you think it's Bullfrog? Or
I don't know. I just want to freaking see the loser.
You just want to see the loser.
The loser.
Oh, man. That's what your father said when your mother held you for the first time. But no.
Oh, yeah, right.
No, I'm just sorry. I'm kidding.
I know, dude.
But you know, oh God, he won't leave me alone, Dr. Earl. God damn it.
Who, Bullfrog?
No, you know.
What's he doing it this time?
Scott won't stop, Earl.
Is
he won't. He just won't stop, man.
Oh, well.
What do you think about
it? I'm not going to say nothing about it. I cannot say anything about it.
Wait, why can't you say anything about it? What are you talking about?
Because there's so much that has been said in the past, you know, and...
Yeah.
Yeah, and if I say somebody, he's going to start going after me, saying, oh, you had your back for how many years? I had your back so-and-so, blah, 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 yeah. You know.
Well, what about when people go after me and you just go along with it? Are you going to say that to them and be like, well, I'm not going to say anything bad about Joe?
No, I'm going to say, hey, Joe's my bud. If you have any issues with Joe, take it up with him privately.
I like it, Dr. Right. Earl. What a trap it was laid for Dr. Earl, and he totally fucking... Holy shit, that was funny as hell. That was real... Earl, that was fucking hilarious, bro. That was funny as fuck.
Well, diplomatic.
Well, Drew said trap for me, and I totally fucking failed.
What did he do? Ask you what 2 plus 2 was?
Was that 10?
What? The fuck?
This guy works on cars.
Yeah, he should work. Yeah, well, thank. I mean, that's not really that good. Well, apparently he was absent on lug nut day because it fell the fuck off. Yeah, you be careful, Casey Israel. I'll boot you out of here quicker than D Moon on a fucking Sunday.
Why,
motherfucker? No, I'm just kidding. I don't know. But anyway, what else is up, Doctor? How you been, man?
Oh, I'm just did a video paying a tribute to Prince, who, as you know, 4 years ago died today.
God, hard to imagine that was that long ago.
Man, 4 years.
House was purple all summer.
No surprise. Everything was purple. Waterfalls in Paris, France was purple in his honor. You know, they had a tribute to him down in downtown Numbers.
Purple cock.
Numbers again.
Purple cock.
I'm surprised they're not doing the Prince night on his birthday like they do with David Bowie annually.
Yeah.
I'll tell you how significant it was that I had the lights purple on my house. We had just won the World Series, and I had had the blue lights up for better part of a year, and I pulled those down to make the house purple for the summer. I mean, that's how significant it was to me.
Yeah, that shit was crazy, man. I mean, I didn't get that crazy, you know, but it was just sucked, like, when Prince died. Like, that, I mean, that shit just sucks. Whenever somebody dies that you grew up loving or whatever for any reason, it's hard, man.
I know. It's like, dude, it was hitting me and my sister like gangbusters. Like, holy shit, this is like one of those news items that just you don't expect to hear. It was awkward enough. Someone in the chat said it was the same time China died.
Wait, China died? Really? Oh, China, the wrestler, yeah.
Yeah, right. The wrestler, yeah. Joni Lauer, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you're right, because me and I think I was live both times. I think I was live for that. Robin Williams, China, Christina Grimmie, like everybody that was, every time somebody died, we were live on like Monetize This or something. It was fucking crazy.
Bush 41. Before.
Yeah, and Jesse was
Bush
on a lot.
Bush 41.
Well, Jesse loves 41. Death.
What?
Bush 41 also died while Monetize This was playing as well.
Who?
Bush 41?
Bush, yeah. George H.W.
Oh,
Bush.
Oh, yeah,
that's
yeah,
what
yeah.
The press office called him.
I'm like, is this some band I don't know about? Bush 41?
I'm thinking like some 41, but you kept saying Bush.
I know, it gets confusing at times. So with all these dumb bands in that these bands come up with nowadays.
Yeah, they are really stupid assholes. I will say that.
Christina Grimmie was the crazy one because it's like not too many people knew her, and Joe was like freaking the fuck out.
I know,
like,
yeah.
Oh, you don't know, you don't understand. And
yeah, it was weird because
it really tugs at the heartstring when you see how that show played out actually that night.
That was messed up.
I didn't
up.
Even know who she was until I saw.
Well, I'd,
I was freaking out about it.
I'd known her from before she was really famous. So like, that's why it was weird because like I sort of like followed her YouTube and she did a cover of something and I was like, this is really good. And then she would talk and then we'd be in like little chat groups with people and then she would talk to us about stuff and I talked to her one time about something. And then so here or there we would still talk about things randomly, like just whatever. And then she got way bigger, and then she was, like, on TV and shit. And, yeah, and then, whatever, not a big deal. Not really that close of friends with her, but just somebody I sort of knew. But then I always followed her to see what she was doing. And then to see that happen, for her to get shot, like, it was just fucking crazy to me. Like, I was...
And I guess the irony is that she was just about to step on that ladder to success, and all of a sudden it was just, like, her life had to be taken at that moment.
Yeah, well, I remember.
Wasn't it her ex, or was it a fan?
It was like a boyfriend or a friend who wanted to be the boyfriend or something. It was.
Oh, okay.
But I think it was an ex who just was an asshole, shit,
disgruntled bullshitter.
And just shot her in the throat, in the head, in front of everyone, and then shot himself.
Yeah, it was kind of like Dimebag Darrell. Yeah, it was a crazy fan. Yeah, same. Except this guy wanted to like be with her. Like, she didn't want to be with him.
Obsession.
Yeah.
One of those ultra obsessed of fans.
And it was weird because all her fans were coming in to our show.
Yeah, I remember that.
That was so weird. And they were like, thank you for doing that. But I felt weird because, like, we were doing this, you know, like, fucked up Monetize This show. And I was still doing the humor. But, like, I would talk about it. And so they were like, oh, thank you. But then, like, we went back into the humor, and I think so many of those girls probably subbed and unsubbed within a couple of days because they were like, like, what the hell is this?
Didn't Muhammad Ali pass away while Monetize This was on, or no?
Oh, God. No, that was...
passed away a long time
ago. Not that I know of, no.
Yeah, no, Muhammad Ali was...
We may have talked about it or something.
You know what? I think you might be right.
Yeah, I remember watching it.
Yeah. Yeah, I think you're right.
You know what's funny? You know what? Actually, it was the week before Christina Grimmie because I just looked her up June 10th. And then June 3rd was Muhammad Ali. So it would have been the same night as Monetize This, exactly yep. 7 days.
It was on Monetize shit. This. You're right. How the fucking, you nailed it.
Yep.
Yeah, China, and China passed away.
And Prince passed away.
On China passed away on April 20th.
Just 2 days ago. Well, 4 years, 2 days
ago. Hey, what do you guys get scarcer now? First story of the day.
And since Dimebag Darrell was mentioned, he also passed away the same night John Lennon got murdered.
What the fuck? Really?
Number 8. Difference, yeah.
Dude, when Dimebag Darrell got killed, I was freaking the fuck out. Like, I want, like, to this day, if I see someone wearing a Columbus Blue Jackets jersey, like, I want to kick him in the head. Like, that guy ruined that team for me. Yeah, the singer from The Voice, and y'all, the little kids are calling in. Yeah, that was crazy. Oh man, yeah, I remember we used to call the pizza joints and do prank calls all the time back and Monetize This. But no, Scott, I don't know, man. I'm not really in a. I don't know. I'm not. Maybe I'll Monetize This Friday night. I'll call, prank call somebody. I remember one time I called them and I was like, "If you don't get here in 5 minutes, I'm not paying for any of this shit." And the guy was like, "Okay, what was your address?" "You know it." And the guy kept asking, and I just kept saying, "You know it." And the guy was freaking out. He's like, "I really don't, man. Like, I'm trying to know it. Like, I'm trying to understand." "You know it. You know it. Don't make me fucking say it again." Oh, God. It just went on and on and on. And then I told Leah, I'm like, "Leah, can you yell in the background? Just say, 'Hey, what the hell?'" And she was like, "No, no, 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 no." Finally, she went like, "Hey, what the hell?" Like, and she did it. And I go, "See? That's my whore of a wife angry at me because you fucked up." Holy shit. I don't know where that video is, but that was a fucking gem. Yeah. Oh, no.
What if the turkeys ate us? What if they filleted us?
Turkeys in the chat.
What if they killed
turkeys.
Us? And ate our children. What if the turkeys ate us? What if they filleted us? If the turkeys ate us, if they had to hate us, Thanksgiving was a little bit different. Instead, the turkeys ate us. They gobbled us apart. But first they'd eat our nuts, and then they'd eat our butt. The turkeys ate us. What if, what if, what if the turkeys ate us? What if the turkeys ate us? What if they ate our What if the turkeys ate us instead of mashed potatoes? Instead the turkeys ate us.
Die turkey die.
Die turkey die. From Broken Lion. Hey, Broken Lion, thank you, man. Broken Lion as always. The blackest man in the chat, baby. Broken Lion and the most badass. And he's now a $50 patron on Patreon. And, bitch, I got to shout out Sith Negan. Last night, Sith Negan dropped 10,000 bits.
Damn.
10,000 bits bomb on Twitch, awesome. Man. Crazy.
Dane, I must have missed that. That's... I must have went to bed after or before that, rather.
Yeah, dude, he dropped the bomb late. It was.
It's
I was just
be like a.
Yeah, I was relaxed.
It's like $100 in bits.
Oh yeah, it's a lot of money.
Yeah.
What the fuck? Oh, another wait. One? Oh my god!
What if the turkeys ate
Holy
us?
Shit!
What if they filleted us?
Sing it again, motherfuckers!
What if they killed us and
the
ate our children?
The chat.
What if the turkeys ate us? What if they filleted us? If the turkeys ate us, if they had to hate us, Thanksgiving was a little bit different.
The big turkey gobbled our fucking assholes up. I'll suck Drew's wife, I'll suck Drew's dyke, I'll suck Drew's testicles that night.
But
yeah, Leah and Tara having sex together, scissoring each other's pussy. Leah and Tara, scissor.
What if the turkeys ate us?
I'm gonna get some chickens.
What if the turkeys ate us instead of mashed potatoes? Instead the turkeys ate us.
Yeah, give me that turkey. What if?
Uncle Joe here is the turkey dono while I clean the bathroom at work. Ribbit, ribbit. Fuck Rob Gronkowski.
Yeah, fuck Rob Gronkowski, that cock-sucking turncoat motherfucker. God damn it, Junebug. Now I'm pissed all over again, Junebug. Thank you. Thank you, though, Junebug. I much appreciate it. The sheetrock was delivered the other day, dude. I got these three giant pallets of sheetrock just sitting in this fucking room. In the other room, it looks ridiculous. I'm going to have to cut it up into these long strips to fix the walls. And I still have no idea. The heating guy has to come back tomorrow to finish the heater. So tomorrow,
paint it.
Well, that doesn't bother me because
actually, you could just put the soundproofing over the top of it. You don't even have to fucking paint.
That's true,
shit.
But I think I'm going to paint it white because if I paint it white, then I can also use lighting better that way. So, you know, there's sort of a vibe,
and there might be some cracks that air could get into and shit. So,
yeah, I'll paint it up. Look at Drew, man, you are looking sexy tonight, Drew. Let me say. That Pepsi logo behind your head, that represents See what it is it means white people in the middle. Like you want, like the blue stands for like fish people from the ocean, Samoans, and the red is for Native Americans, and the white means white people. So you want to be sandwiched by Native Americans and Samoans.
So what does the crybaby bitch next to it mean?
That means that you actually worship crybaby bitches and cucks, and you are one. So, doesn't that make perfect sense, right? You know, I mean, come on, fucking Chinny the Pooh. All right,
Chinny the Pooh.
I don't know, bro.
My name is Kane, and I'm donating.
I stepped away for a moment. Did you guys play the Twitch thought video?
Oh, no.
If so, I'll rewind.
I haven't played it yet, actually. Where was it again? On Twitter? Justin Gregory, thank you, man. It's actually a good thing you brought it up because I totally forgot. Where the fuck is it? I don't know where it is.
It's Twitch thought video?
I can't find it. I don't
Something
know what
or...
I don't know what he's saying.
Thought. I think it's a term for the street term for hoe.
Yeah, but no. But I don't know where right. But I don't know where the video is. That's my problem.
Oh, is it the chick that was like, "You gotta have $5, or you can't be in my chat," or something like that? She's trying to do a.
Oh,
bad
you mean
bunny
bad
thing.
Bunny?
So she's trying to be super bad bunny?
No. Yeah, she was like trying to. It was like she saw what happened with Bad Bunny. She's like, "Oh, I gotta do that now."
Oh gosh!
If it's the same one, I don't know. I mean, there's always weird shit coming out of Twitch, but
I think it is. Yeah.
I mean, is it Alinity or whatever her name is? That chick?
I didn't even catch her name. Someone posted it with no comment or anything.
Or is
on
this
it,
that just... Lou chick? That Lulu chick or whatever? There's a million of them, dude.
Whores. I don't know.
I mean, like this. If this is the chick I'm thinking of, she's been exposed by many of my friends before. Many people that I'm friends with have exposed this chick. I think Jeremy from The Quartering got her, too. I can't remember. What a fuck she is. My buddy...
You're checking into that. Paul 3 in the chat, he wanted to know if we knew who... So, Nathan Gale is the name of the guy who shot Dimebag Daryl. But who shot Nathan Gale?
The police officer.
Was his name?
An off-duty police officer who was there that night.
I don't remember the cop's name, unfortunately. You're right. Yeah, and that guy came in like a badass with a shotgun.
Tell you this, if you saw his name, you'd never
forget. Him for the breakup at Pantera, I believe it was.
Is it Dickie or something like that? Like Dick something?
It's an R away from a very bad word.
Rapist.
James, I'll try it, okay? Oh, Jesus Christ. James Niggemeier.
Oh, shit. Oh, dear.
There you go, Jesus. Paul.
I'm surprised you didn't make me do it, Drew.
I found her name, but what's the video that I'm specifically supposed to play on her? If you tweeted it to me and I didn't, you need to retweet it to me. Oh yeah, you just liked it. Okay, I found it. Now I found it because you liked it. All right, let me pull it up. Let's see what we got here. Let's see what we got here. Let's see how big a pussy is.
It doesn't really matter how much money you make or how much money you have. That's really the thing. Because I'm not asking you for a large financial contribution. If it costs $20 to sub, $20 is quite a bit of money. $20 is you can get a full meal for $20. And the difference of $20 and eating a meal is in that $20. Like, that's where it is. But a sub is $5 at maximum. In whatever your currency is, it's maybe $10. And it doesn't matter how broke you are. If you have time to watch Twitch, you have $10, truly. If you don't have $10, you probably don't have time to watch Twitch because you should be working. You should be trying to earn money. It's not a ton. It's not like a ton of money. So being like, I'm broke, I can't afford to sub, that doesn't really track. What you mean to say is, I'm so irresponsible with my money, I can't support the entertainment that I enjoy.
Oh gosh.
I'm unemployed, so basically all my money goes to bills and food, or I would support you.
She expects us to pay or give her money.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Fuck that, bitch.
It's $5. It's really, like, no one's gonna convince me that what I'm saying is so rude or so unacceptable or so outrageous. It just simply isn't.
Yeah, she's totally ripping off Bad Bunny, man.
It doesn't cost you that much to sub. And oh, God. It's very, very wonderful because it allows streamers to continue supporting their $5 content. That's all.
It's not even that big. This isn't even that big a deal to me. This is just a sales pitch. Like, everyone's getting so mad. I'm not even mad about this. This is just a big sales pitch.
Here's what I'm mad about is the cunty fucking look on her face the whole time she's saying it. Like, yeah, you could be a little less of a fucking dipshit bitch about it when you say it. Like, you know you have $5. You can, like, totally do it because...
That's the thing that gets me.
Fuck off, whore.
Yeah,
it's better use this for $5.
You know, some sympathetic simp fuck will give her the money, though, too.
Yeah.
There's nothing wrong with, you know, supporting people on YouTube, Twitch, or anything like that. It's not that. It's there's a way to do it, and being a cunt about it isn't the way to do it.
You know, quite honestly, I mean... If you increased my audience to her audience size, like, let's say you made this audience watching me right now, like, how many people does she have watching her live? Probably thousands or something, right? But if you increased, you know, right on my, we're on my backup channel right now. On my backup channel, we get about 300 something watching us right now here on my backup channel. Right now, right here. I mentioned the donation link once at the beginning of this stream. Like, that, oh, we don't, super chats don't work and whatever. And people have more covered for this show more than possible. I'm surprised that somebody like her would really have to beg about it, you know? Explain the value of her content. And I'll give you the key to success. I'll give her the key to success. If she actually wants men to invest in her and pay more money for her, instead of saying you should pay more money for me, the smarter thing to do would to start being more personal with the viewers you have. And then men would start to feel like they are connected with you. And then because of that, they would actually donate more to you than this. There's actually a psychology to that. So she's actually doing, she doesn't need to do this. She doesn't need to come on and say, do you understand, like, the money you should be giving me and the value of whatever the fuck I do? Instead, if she opened up about personal experiences and the men's personal experiences and had them donate for, like, what they want to say about her, compliment her, hate on her, or if they want to bring up something private in their life, maybe she can tell, give them her advice. She'd actually probably make more money than ever doing something like that.
Yes.
Oh, my God. Yeah. Eric in the chat absolutely. Just said she needs to meet O.J. Simpson.
I saw that earlier. Oh, dude.
I saw that, too. I'll kill another white bitch. I'll kill this white bitch, and then I'll take her $5. Thanks for the $5.
I'll give you for $5.
I'll fucking cut her pussy out, and I'll show it to her dad for $5.
For $5, like, I'll show you what I do for $5.
I skin her fucking beaver.
How you promote your stuff, Joe? I have no problem with it at all. Like, I love supporting everyone I like.
Well, I get called a major e-beggar by a lot of people. Like, oh, he's a crazy e-beggar and stuff like that. But I think there's a difference. I think that my show is tailored around donations, and I certainly need them to do these shows. But I don't think that I once I mentioned about, oh yeah, the donations are below, remember, okay, anyway, on to the show now. And people are going to do what they do. But if I had her audience size, but it was my show, but like, so if she's got 5,000 viewers, if we had 5,000 viewers on this show, I think we would outdo her. And I don't even have titties to show you. Well, I kind of do, but I don't have female titties to show you. So, I don't know. I just think there's another way to do it. But I get what she's doing. I think she is just ripping off Bad Bunny. I think she saw that, like you said, and she's like, ooh, I know what I can do.
Absolutely.
I'm going to get
this. I instantly thought about
this. Oh, shit. Here it is. Are you watching, bitch? Is this bitch watching my show now? Look at this. $7. That's more than $5, you cunt. You fucking... Goddamn. That fucking cunt.
So Mies and Y underscore society are waiting. I want to hear their thoughts on Bullfrog.
Why society needs to learn how to use his microphone.
Why society can't get his fucking mic to work. So Why society got 3 chances and he failed at all of them. So.
The thing that irks me about this bitch is that she's dressed so provocatively, trying to cater to the lonesome boys out there.
Yes. Yes.
I'm not going to hate on a hustle.
Yes.
But do it right, at least.
Harry Steve.
So I got the new coronavirus symptom, called COVID toes. I may get COVID penis next.
Oh, man. Yeah. You know, I've really been worried about COVID toes. That's the one. Because I heard it spreads to your balls. So, like, that's really something that I am concerned about, Harry Steve. So I thank you for bringing it up. You might have just brought an awareness to it.
What
is the turkey?
Second encore.
What if they filleted us? What if they killed us and ate our children?
How's this, you
what
thought,
if
bitch?
The turkeys ate us? What if they filleted us? If the turkeys ate us, if they had to hate us, Thanksgiving was a little bit different. Instead, the turkeys ate us. They gobbled us apart. But first they'd eat our nuts, and then they'd eat our butt. The turkeys ate us. What if the turkeys ate us?
Yeah.
What if the turkeys ate us?
Go ahead, eat it. Go ahead, suck it. go ahead and fuck
what
it.
What if they ate a fucking nut? What if the turkeys ate us instead of mashed potatoes? Instead the turkeys ate us.
Turkeys run for your lives.
My son champ. My son champ, thank you, man. Bulls, D. Welsh dropped a 50 bomb earlier. I forgot about that. Thanks to D. Welsh. My son champ, thank you. And yeah, I don't even hate on this girl. I don't care. You know, it's just stupid shit. It's just stupid. Like I said, I appreciate the hustle of any girl too. If she wants to call our audience cocksuckers and, you know, donate to me, you poor little lazy boy faggots or something, and then she gets donated to. I mean, I don't care. It doesn't hurt me. I mean, people, who, you know, however you make your money, whatever. If you can talk your fucking somebody into giving you that money on there, I mean, fuck it. You know what I mean?
I think it's hurting her.
What was that?
I think it's honestly hurting her.
Well, I don't think it's hurting her now because now she's got all this attention.
Ho, 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 Mary.
Oh, shit.
Damn.
Here comes Santa.
Night. I got too drunk on Christmas night.
Boom!
I should've hung myself from the Christmas lights. I got too fucking drunk on Christmas night. I got too fucking drunk on Christmas night.
Look at that!
I should've hung myself from the Christmas lights. I got too fucking drunk on Christmas night.
Yeah.
I hope Santa runs me over with his goddamn sleigh. I should've got drunk on Christmas.
Ho, ho, ho. Yo, Six. We gotta make some noise for Six in the chat, man. He has been going off all week. He's even gotten a mod wrench now, and he's been... I'll tell you what, man. He has been just fucking people up. Actually, really hasn't, but he's been awesome. Six, thank you, Six.
I think... with that fall, I think Santa might have E now.
Yeah, he's
or brain hemorrhage.
That is a concussions. Horrific. Yeah, it's a concussion for sure. That's a horrific fall. Boom.
Yeah.
No. That's scary to watch, man. Honest.
You know what though? That's actually better than hitting the pavement. Like, it's better that he hit that car. Like.
Yeah, that's true. Good point.
Like, if he had fallen over just onto that pavement in that parking lot. That would have been fucking devastating if he hit his head.
I can imagine it'd be a hit a huge brick stump there.
Oh my God.
I think he
curb stomped himself.
I think he went straight for the concrete. I think his shoulder would hit. Not
what else we got?
Yeah.
Oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it. That's
want
it.
Some bubbly? Look at this stuff. Oh, oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it.
How when will OJ call in to claim his crown and that wasn't that bad, but that Twitch whore needs a BBC in her mouth that will shut her up.
Yeah, dude, there's something about that for me, too. I started picturing a black dude just pounding her until she was in pain. It's very weird how I felt that way, but I did. It's very weird. You know, I was listening to a show the other night, and it was just... Okay, I was listening to Loveline the other night. Because I've been talking about that. I've been watching all the retro shows. And I love how, like, most of the calls start with, like, hey, you know, Michelle, you're 12.
Joe, you were talking about prank calls earlier. It got me thinking your best prank call was Bret Hart calling Yellow Cab. Hash the Summer Slam.
The Summer Slam. Well, that's a fake prank call.
I was going to say, that's...
That one doesn't...
You fooled another one.
I fooled another one, yeah. That was, Do people really not know that? Wow. I mean,
to be honest, I didn't at first. It took me a while to pick up on it myself.
A lot of people
I didn't even know.
A lot of people thought it was real. Yeah, no, that's that was Meek. I'm the Indian guy. Listen really carefully.
Are you in Boston or are you outside there?
Well, you know, I'm the best there is.
The
best there ever was.
Outside the city, we cannot pick you up. If you're in the Boston, then we can pick you up there.
I'm in the greatest country on earth right now.
What?
I'm in a cabin.
Fill my
May I have your zip code? I need your zip code, sir.
My name is Bret the Hitman Hart. And all you Americans make me damn sick.
What town are you in? What city? Are you in Boston or outside the city?
I'm in Calgary, Alberta, Canada.
Calgary?
Calgary.
I do not know where Calgary is. That's the part of Boston.
Stu Hart. Calgary Stampede. Maybe you heard of it. Maybe you hear of it if all the Americans weren't brainwashed, you crazy asshole.
I cannot hear you. There's lots of music. If you're at a party, could you go outside? I cannot hear over the music.
I have a party every day because I'm the best.
Give me a hell yeah!
Sex line tonight, Joe.
Broken Lion. What's up, Broken Lion? You know, I haven't been able to call the sex line because they've got me like banned or something. They've got my number banned and my credit card apparently.
Here's an idea for a rant line. Let's
call on to you then.
No, I'm gonna fix it. I am gonna fix it. But right now, I still have
all the numbers.
I haven't
have the community
yet.
Members do sex line calls and send them in for the rant line.
There
you go.
Yeah, I mean, listen, you can do any prank. Anybody can prank call anybody and then send it in, right? Always put it on the rant line.
Like the theme one night.
No, but I will. I'll do another one. But yeah, that was me. I was the Indian guy. I mean, people thought it was real.
I thought it was real too.
It was awesome. I thought it was well done. I called on my cell phone and recorded the Indian guy part. Like separately, so I called on a cell phone, and I was like, "Oh, not." So I had to react as Bret Hart to that. It was kind of hard.
Wow. But,
yeah, pretty crazy.
You should probably put up a compilation of all your best sex calls, so either load it up on your Patreon or here on YouTube.
I did have a playlist, but I have to re-upload everything. There's so many calls, dude. So many calls. Casey is raw. Let me tell you something, man. If I nutted on your chest, my sperm is so fucking like healthy for you that if I came on your fucking chest, you would never get cancer again. Like ever in your life, you wouldn't get cancer. My sperm counts would heal your cellular degeneration of your epididymis.
Like it would cure me of everything, like future STDs, if I get anything.
I don't know if it can protect against that. Let's not go too crazy, all right? But I mean, you know, because that's just, you know, just don't fuck a girl without a condom. But you know, as far as cancer goes, you never know when that's going to creep up. My cum will protect your skin barrier, and it will give you all this just fucking nutrients and stuff like that. I mean, the cure for cancer, who would know, is in my jizz.
I think your cum would stop ADTR from breathing into his microphone.
I was going to say.
Does that mean I can't shower no more? I have to keep your cum on my chest?
Yes. No. No.
On my chest?
No, your skin will absorb my cum like you absorb a cheeseburger when you haven't eaten in 2 hours. It will be phenomenal, Casey is raw. It will be... Like, you'll be protected forever. You talk about, like, the corona antiviruses and all these things. Like, your skin, like, it will just be this protective layer that it will really keep you safe, I believe, for a long time. Listen, I'm no doctor, but, bro, this shit's going to protect the fuck out of you.
I would be honored.
I know you would. And you know what?
Bet you right now, all the people going through cancer right now is probably lining up outside your house with a bunch of little miniature cups.
Yeah. Coming to get a sample of Christ Cronin. Christ Cronin's come. Cronin come. Dude, imagine if I could. I bet you I could convince people into that, too. And the people would line up. Like, you know what I mean? 500 folks line up in front of a man's house who claims he has the cure for cancer. Every 2 hours, he goes into the bathroom and masturbates. And the news crew comes out, and I come out of the bathroom with, like, black under my eyes, like, looking wicked sleepy and tired, and, like, my dick is, like, raw from just jerking off every 2 hours. Like,
big hair on your palms.
Like, have you ever, sir, thought about giving it a rest for a little while? No. A lot of people say that you're ripping vulnerable folks off and really charging people $800 per load. I mean, that's seems like it's a little crazy. Every fucking 2 hours, I make $800.
would be an asshole if I, after I get it on my chest, if I scoop it up and try to sell it on eBay.
Yeah, you try to resell it.
Would that be an asshole move?
Probably would be, yeah. And there'd be people like, there'd be people out there who are like selling counterfeit Cronin cum.
Bottling used oil.
Yeah, and
trying to sell it.
And then there would other people with the last name Cronin would be trying to sell their cum, pretending they were the real guy. And like, my cancer didn't heal. And it was like, it was counterfeit cum. That would be, I mean, this is a movie waiting to happen.
It's a hashtag right there, counterfeit cum.
Why is nobody picked?
And I'm thinking the same thing. They should make it upload it on Pornhub.
You know, they should make you a cholesterol blanket, Casey.
Oh my god.
Yeah, like when you're sleeping in a blanket, a little thing hooks up to your IV and the blanket tells you your counts. You know?
That'd be pretty bad.
You could sleep easy then. I swear to God, it'd be great. But no, we really got to get out of here. This show is supposed to be an hour or two, maybe. And I got to tell you, I think the show is... We almost did 4 hours of Throwdown.
Wow.
Jesus Christ, wow. Bro.
It was three.
Well, I started at 10:30.
Yeah. 3 hours.
Oh, yeah, you're right.
Man, this has been four.
Why don't
start early?
Why do the numbers? Oh my God! Wait a minute, Robert Heller.
Let me get fucked up. Tonight I'm getting fucked up. Tonight we're getting fucked up. Tonight we're getting fucked up. Yeah, I get fucked up. So pass me some of that vodka and pass me some of that ecstasy and give me some of that pussy. Tonight I'm getting fucked up.
Come on.
Whatever happened to Dilk Wilkerson?
Dilk Wilkerson. People bashed him one night, and they didn't care about him anymore, so I just kind of gave him the boot. Robert Heller, what's up, bro? Yeah, you got coronavirus.
Oh, if Tommy and Bullfrog go at it again, you could have bring him back to be the announcer.
That's a great idea.
Oh, Dilk Wilkerson, yeah. They're going at it now. Fucking, oh, my God, the fat guy's got his hand on him.
They needed a commentator for Friday because there's so much fucking dead air between the two of them.
Yeah, it was really bad. I think Tommy just decided he wasn't going to engage. And Bullfrog really had already said everything crazy that he could say. So,
But like I said last Friday, he needs to up his game up a little bit.
Ooh, Bullfrog?
Yes, definitely. Because, you know, he's been known to say the same things over and over and
shit
over and over. Like,
right.
Show a factory at Succum Scum and Tommy I ass fucked crystal black semen shower.
What the fuck, damn. AJ Adams? What the fuck did you just say? Let me pull that up on the screen again. AJ Adams said, ugh. Now that's being a shit bum, brother.
Damn.
That is being a full on shit bum. That is some crazy shit bum talk. Wow. Look at that bum bum. Now, right now, Tommy NC is probably watching this stream still awake, and he's jerking off to that bum bum cartoon. I can almost guarantee.
$100.
What the fuck?
Donation time.
Damn. Holy shit.
Boy.
Oh my God!
Sing me a song, Joe.
Oh
June
my
bug.
God, June Bug!
Wow,
$100!
Yes.
Damn bullfrog! Ribbit, 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 ribbit.
Just dancing to this.
Why does everybody make fun of me?
Look at Big
I
Show.
Need somebody to pound my froggy ass.
June Bug is here. And he's hard.
Shut up, you Canadian bitch. When you get a green card. Ribbit, rip, rip. Ribbit, rip, rip. I wanna ride Cronin's dick. Ribbit, rip, rip. Ribbit, rip, rip, ribbit. I just wanna pound his dick. Steve
tell him made a video of me and I wanna pound his froggy ass. Ribbit, rip, 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 ribbit, ribbit, rip, 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 rip. I wanna see Monica's tits. I'm the bullfrog. I'm the bullfrog. My favorite number is blue. Oh my, my favorite color is number 3. I wanna see Drew come on me. Rip, Canadian bitch. Why don't you get a green card, you Foxborough bitch? Yeah, hey, my daughter is my niece. I'm jealous of my brother cause he got a bad wife.
Oh.
She threw up on me, said get a fucking line. Rip, Cronin's dick. He shaved his face cause of me, I shaved it with a fucking razor. Yeah. She's gonna leave her boyfriend.
A little bit of the bubbly.
That's it.
Want some bubbly? Look at this stuff.
Here we go.
Oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it.
Did you see Drake Maverick's wife got an OnlyFans? iDubbbz girl and people are clowning him for it. Can't airfully it to make one so I can hold a month-long nut then just explode all over those pics of her cooter beaver taco. Zany face, relieved face, kissing.
Oh, she got on OnlyFans. You know, somebody told me to go on OnlyFans once. Is OnlyFans just basically a... I thought OnlyFans was basically just like a Patreon type of thing. Are you saying it's like a sex place or something?
Thought it was, yeah, like Patreon for people over 18.
Oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it.
Want
that's
some
it.
Bubbly?
Yeah.
Look
that's,
at this
all
stuff.
Right, yeah.
Oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it.
Drew's wife doesn't need OnlyFans. She's too busy with projects getting her fat stank cunt fucked by a porch monkey. What the fuck?
What the hell?
Jesus. Holy shit, dude. That's some fucked up shit, bro.
Damn.
That's rough, Barry McCoykiner.
McCoykiner?
McCoykiner?
McCoykiner? Oh. Barry McCoykiner.
Barry McCoykiner.
That might be better than Phil McCrevis.
They're just lucky that I'm fucking retarded and I can't read shit anyway. So, like, I fucked even that up. Oh, Dave Rose, come on.
Yeah.
Well, you guys blew the goal away tonight. I was looking for, hopefully, maybe to get to a hundy, and that was just taking a dump on. Take that, you thought bitch. How you like my fans, you thought whore? My fans are better than your fans, you thoughty bitch. All right, thank you, guys. This was crazy. What an ending. Follow me at CorruptedPod on Twitter. Hopefully you follow me on this channel if you haven't already. Over 4,000 people stopped in here tonight, and they're all hard for it. Thanks to Maxwell7, who became a Patreon. Patreon.com/JoeCronin. Check out Patreon. And stuff coming this week. We were really off for about a week. Not very much content last past week because all the shit that went down. But I've got a bunch of shit coming, so including me and Leah's podcast and much more. Me and my wife's podcast, Till Death Do Us podcast. Corrupted podcast, Saturday night. We'll find out what the crew's going to be this Saturday. I had to fire D-Moon for being gay with Justin Bailey. A little too much.
Jeez.
And Dr. Earl, me and Dr. Earl got a show coming. That's coming up.
We got to definitely DM each other about when we want to do this, definitely.
Right, and I have a brand new show coming, too, where I'm just going to be doing a show and... I'm going to have a different guest on or co-host on every time, and that's coming as well. Anybody can be on it, as long as you at least can talk a little bit, and we'll do stuff, man, and I'll include Arknolia Strokelbean in that one for sure, because he's owed a bunch of them, and a bunch of other still people.
You've still got 6 Monetize This Post shows that are in the bin right now.
That's right. Oh, that's the big announcement. Every day this week, I'm going to be trying to get out an episode of the post show of Monetize This, which are like... anywhere from 20 minutes to 2 hours long. So,
this last one. Fucking, awesome. I tried to end the fucking thing like 6 different times.
Oh,
Famous
my God.
B was just ready to go.
Famous B probably wanted to die. I think Scott,
like, man,
Scott was going
you know,
off.
Because we went late and I was going to do a shorter one. Then I saw Famous B come on at the end. I'm like, there's no way we're ending this early. No right. fucking way. It's been too long.
Yeah. But to all the fucking all the haters out there, suck me off. Make sure you guys follow me on Twitch, twitch.tv/JoeCroninJCS, because you never know when I'm going to go live on there with my gaming streams. Gaming streams will be back maybe tomorrow. I thought we were going to play tonight, but maybe I am going to play tonight. I don't fucking know. Dude, I'll tell you what. I am fucking feeling horrible in the basement. When I'm down here, I, like, lose my breath. But I can't tell if it's from talking. It's almost I almost wonder if it's from talking too much.
Has that heavy patched up that leak in that one pipe that you showed? I think it was on Twitter.
No, not yet. But the new heater,
oh boy.
The new heater's going in tomorrow, so that won't even exist anymore. That pipe won't even need to be there anymore because the guy is ventilating the exhaust of the heater and the carbon monoxide and all that, whatever you want to call it.
And that's what it was. I'm thinking as well.
Well, I did test. I tested the whole basement with a extreme tester, like that even picks up below a ppm or whatever. And I'm not getting any readings of it anywhere. But you know, there is the.
Did you contact the guy who you bought the house from, and did you wring his neck?
Well, I mean, you know,
what the fuck did you sell me, man?
I mean, he really didn't do anything. I mean, to be honest, like it's just. You know, a major storm happened and a leak came in, and I think these are just little issues that have, you know, been here. Nothing, it's not major. I don't think it's as major as the pictures make it seem like. It's just that, you know, it's weird. I don't know. I can't quite put my finger on it, man. It could be acid reflux, too. I almost wonder if the acid reflux really burned me up in the top of my chest, and that's sort of some of the pain I'm getting. Maybe there's some scarring in the top of my chest or something from acid reflux. And it's simulating it's weird, dude.
And maybe in your lower throat, because you can get like scar tissue build up in your throat from acid reflux. Old boss of mine, it happened to his wife. She had to have him like scraped out and shit.
Yeah. I almost wonder about that. It's right below my throat, like right in that crevice there. It feels like it's weird. You know, I don't know. It's very weird, but yeah, man. Anyway, I'm out of here. We'll talk about it.
Okay.
I'll see you tomorrow for the AEW review, and I'm sure I'll be live a couple times throughout the day. Thank you guys for a beast night. Thanks to Tommy for stopping by, and Casey is raw. Drew the Gatekeeper from Derailed. Casey is raw. Oh, Dr. Erlin. Oh, no. He's here.
We were talking about him.
Good God, he's here.
Things are kind of happening. What the fuck is happening? Aliens. Extraterrestrials. They gave me a shot. Nanotechnology. I'm not me. You're not you. La la la. I'm fucking crazy, split personality, Scott McKinnon. La 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 la.
There he is, folks. Holy fuck, bro. Holy fuck. Hit that like button, everybody. Let's see if we can get to 200 likes. Six, man. Six going full fucking beast mode again. Thank you, Six. I love you, brother. What a bomb. What a song.
It ended.
That's a good way to end it, but now I got to find a closing song to really end it. Although I enjoy that.
Hey, is that really Scott who's singing that, or was that you, Joe?
What? Joe. What are you fucking crazy? That's me.
It really sounds like Scott.
Well, yeah.
That was the point.
I was mocking it. Like, there's something going on.
It was a mock. It was a spoof. It was a parody.
That episode predates you, though, doesn't it? Because that was like monetize this, what, like 150 or some shit like that? Yeah, no, it was earlier than that, even, I think.
It was like in the 130s.
I'm just saying, it just really sound like Scott.
I'll take the compliment, man. I'll take the compliment, though.
Scotty! Scotty!
Man.
You kept us up all night last night, both of us. Fucking yelling back and forth, in and out of the fucking house. Fucking pissing off.
This is the remix.
The remix of his landlord yelling at him.
Done fucked up, kept us up. Why you always gotta be busting a nut in your bed? I hear you, you get head, you have Jews in your bed. You suck them off, you swallow them, get them off. Shut the fuck up, Scotty, why you always wake my bitch and me up? Every night at 10, you fucking wake again. You screaming in the fucking camera like fucking end. It won't end, you got no zen, you got no calm, you got no chill. You always drinking, you always taking the pills and you're pissing me off. I guess next time I might kick you out. I might bang down your door and yell at you because you won't stop shouting. Why the fuck won't you just shut the fuck up? Yo, Scotty, why you always gotta be waking me up?
Hi.
Waking us up, Scotty. Why you wake us up?
You kept us up all night last night, both of us.
I guess you got no manners, and you got no bananas. You nuts as fuck, you always fucking talking shit, but got no love. Yeah, you got no love, got no respect. What the heck? You always screaming, I'm about to break your neck. Yeah, I hear you talk about Joe and everybody. I cannot sleep, I'm gonna make you bloody. Cause I can't get sex because you're so stressed. You're screaming and you're pissing me off and all the rest. The neighbors call the cops, you won't knock it off. Why won't you shut up? Why won't you just shut off? Yeah, I think I might have to buy a razor blade. Cut your throat, watch you fucking bleed. Yeah, I made you slayed. Shoddy, Scotty, please stop being fucking naughty. Everybody's sick of this, you make us pissed. Slit your wrist, yeah, slit your wrist. The morning of Christmas. Why'd you shut the fuck up before I make you die? Everything you ever said in your fucking life. You make me mad, you make me scream. You make me wanna be really fucking mean. Scott, go to sleep, go to sleep, go to sleep. You're pissing off me. Go to sleep, go to sleep.
Fucking do, man. Not a fucking single donation. I've been live for fucking, it feels like fucking ages. Not a donation, nothing, man. Not a sign of appreciation. Nothing but, I went live to get nothing but more dislikes than likes. I feel great. I feel loved, man. I feel so loved. I'll tell you one thing, man. Drama Club and me and the rest of us, we're never going to succeed unless likes overcome the dislikes.
All the motherfuckers out there try to diss me. Bullets must be made for make-believe because they miss me. All I ever hear is how you're talking behind my back. Better be careful, I will drown you in a bath. Tub, tug, blood spilled on a rub. Yo, rub-a-dub-dub, this will go and need a scrub. Looking for a hug, cause I fill you up with drugs. Drag you to the porch, then throw you over easy. You're no longer breathing, murder in the season. I do it for a goddamn good reason. Yo, put on some dungarees and... Are you gonna try to talk tough when you're 5'3"? Go get a lawyer, yo, cease and desist me. I cut out your kidneys and sell them on Wall Street. Like your Larry Funk, except your liver is... Okay, yo, just fucking go gay. Get over with. I always like gotta this. Hear about your fucking ass each day. Ugh. I told everyone about a pedo named Stacy. Everyone said I was the bad guy being mean. How you feel now that he fucks with boys 15? DJ forever play, DJ forever pray. Only kid's innocence, I bet he claims innocence. You know he smells underage scents. Need a couple bullets in his hippocampus. You fucking gross bitch, Ross sucks dick. That's why I wrote this rap, that's why I wrote this rhyme. Yo, I can take five pussies at a fucking time. Fuck you DJ forever gay, Stacy. And fuck everyone who ever fucking talk bad about me. Yo, fucking hate every day, but y'all motherfuckers going leather gone gay. I'm straight up inside your mom's puss, I'm busting nuts. Everybody here can shut the motherfuck up. Joe Cronin is ready, I bought a bunch of guns. And if you wanna step to me, I'll kill every fucking one of you. Yo, I'll kill nuns. And you will kill none. Take your best shot, you bunch of motherfuckers. Fight every. I'm about to kill people, I'm about to start a fight. Everyone knows vigilantes come out at night. Lucky this parking lot's so bright. Or I might have choked you out, hold you down low, out of sight. Look into the words with all your might. My brain's on ecstasy and I'm taking flight. Yo, dial it back before I give another old lady a heart attack. These words are so intense, they affected the sex life of Mike Pence. Justin Bailey left, cause he quits. Now he sucks on Harry Cock, cause he a little bitch. Yo, why you always talking so much shit? It's because my own mother was a hateful fucking bitch. My dad died when I was 8. It filled me with this hate. I'm sure half the audience relates.
Man, that's from when JB left the last time. Wow, man, that's some old shit. That's some old shit. That's some old shit from way back when. From way back when. All right, I'm really out of here. Goodbye, everybody. Fuck you, Debbie. Goodbye, everybody. Good night. For real. Thank you for the donations, man. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Big time.
I had about enough.
Good night.
Of all these filthy motherfuckers.
Episode 90 next week, yeah. Shit. We're coming up to 100 episodes.
They're complaining about shit. How about you shut the fuck up? Before the JCS army has to fucking tear you apart and leave you for the fucking vultures, you faggot ass fucks.
Ooh. Drop the F-bomb.
So sick about talking this shit. Always somebody complaining about it. Man, just shut the fuck up, turn it off. You fucking motherfuckers are soft. Eat shit, will you swallow my dick? Will you suck on my prick? Will you eat my fucking cum with? Yeah, put the spoon in your mouth and take it out. Shove it up your ass, kill yourself. Grab a gun, maybe end your life. Put a bullet in your head, then bullet in your wife. Except you don't have a wife, cause you ugly as fuck. Yo, grab a knife, slit your throat, you might die. Put my finger to the fucking sky, scream out loud. Yeah, fuck this, fuck you bitch, yo, fuck Debbie. Fuck you, Debbie. Sick of her shit, always complaining about this. Eat my shit, you'll swallow my piss. So, you bitch. Fuck you, Debbie. Fuck you, Debbie. Fuck you, Debbie. Fuck you, Debbie. Fuck you, Deb A. You gay, so shut the fuck up. Listen what I say. Yeah, I'm filled with hate. I was playing nice at first, but then you made it worse. Time to grab my pen, start writing again. Turn you to a hen. I'm a fucking wolf, I'll rip your wings off again. Debbie, shut the fuck up, you stupid goddamn bitch. You make me sick. Yo, Maz Mira, look into the mirror. then realize, motherfucking fat ass, you ain't getting thinner. Oh man, baby, check your teeth, you cunty ass faggot, haven't brushed in a fucking week. Your shit is weak, you cannot sneak. Y'all talking shit about me behind me, but the truth leaks. And now you done fucked up because I raped your butt. Your fucking girlfriend's an ugly slut, and you never fuck her no more, you a mutt. Swallow all my cum. Yo, young Republican, your dad is fucking done. Too soon he gonna die. And as I put my fist and middle finger to the sky.
Oh, that was fun. Goodbye, everybody. Everybody in the chat, I want you to type 69 and draw your biggest cock. Good night, everybody.